test run. See if this whole thing actually works.
I mean, you were able to record your screen and the audio from when you did that Zarek Dark Souls thing. So
yeah, the difference is that wasn't live. I was literally just recording it.
Well, still, you probably used OBS for that, right?
I did, in fact, use OBS for that. Yes.
Yeah. So it might already be set up that way.
I mean, I would hope so. Shoot. Okay. How are we looking with this whole thing? Okay, that actually doesn't look half bad so far. There's like a little 3 or 5 second delay between like when I actually do. Okay. Let me see how that looks.
So, Mr. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
How do you pronounce your name again?
Bonjour.
Thank you. So, I'm looking at your resume, and I do see some good stuff here. That being said, most of it has to do with guarding caravans.
You hear that?
Yeah, I'm hearing it from your end.
Oh, okay, cool. Oh, I know. That wasn't even the right one. Hang on. It's from there. Wrong. Yeah, okay, so I heard it from...
Oh, no. That wasn't even the right one. Hang on.
Oh, man, that audio is so deep fried. Oh, Jesus Christ, what have I done? This is horrible. Okay. That is very, very unfortunate with how that audio sounds. Okay, like, describe what you guys are hearing right now, because, it's pretty messy where I am. That is one big hecking oof.
But then again, that's hearing from Discord, which is hearing from like your audio, from what I'm hearing, Discord rather than the actual stream thing.
Yeah, that's true.
Do you have like a stream on private or something?
Yeah, I do have the stream on private. Okay, let's see. I'm supposed private. How the hell do I share it with other people?
Try posting a link.
Unlisted.
Oh, unlisted.
If that's an option.
Oh, unlisted. Okay.
That's what works better.
Unlisted. Okay. Changes are being saved. All changes saved. All greater than. Unlisted, and then just...
Yeah, just copy-paste the link.
Oh, the server URL? Or...
No, the YouTube video.
Oh, okay. I think this is the right one.
Nope, that brings up my live streaming.
That brings up your live streaming? What?
I think that's your channel's live stream. You have to find the video URL.
Oh god, this is horrible. Okay, sure. I'll go do that real quick.
Three hours later.
Literally. That's not.
It's only been 30 minutes.
That's better than yesterday, at least. But this is a lot more ambitious, so I don't know. Basic info.
One eternity later.
Several eternities later.
At this point, the apocalypse has already happened, so what's the point?
Ugh.
How
about this?
Yeah, I was going to say, at the bottom corner of that dashboard page, there's a share thing that says the YouTube video URL.
Uh-huh. Okay. What about the one I just posted? Does that one work?
Oh, yeah, that's working.
Ooh, wonderful. All right, then. So how does it sound right
now?
Actually,
it doesn't sound that bad.
Oh, really? Not too crunchy? The audio doesn't sound too deep-fried?
Yeah, we're echoing a little bit. I think that might, if you have your speakers on.
Okay, I'm going to try something real quick. I'm going to, like, plug in my actual Yeti mic and see if that actually, like, makes things sound a little better.
You seem when listening to the live stream, yours seems fine, although Connor's audio seemed a little hecked.
Like, yeah, I think that's because it's playing through his speakers,
uh-huh.
And it's picking up on his
mic. I mean, if your guys' audio is a little bit crunchy, we can work with that as long as it's not, like, super garbled and no one can understand it.
I mean, Wombat, how do I sound in a stream?
Hold on.
I'll keep talking so you can hear.
Yeah, like, I'm relying pretty heavily on you guys right now to, like...
Yeah, you're echoing pretty much, Shade.
Yeah, you seem to be that well, as well.
That is, yeah, I don't really see a way to, like, how the hell do I remove the echo? Literally just Google it. How to fix echo in OBS. How the hell do I... OBS sound echo fix. Simple and quick.
Right,
we
maybe
can
I'll
watch
add...
You Google it.
Yeah, add Discord to that as well.
From there you're going to select the audio tab, and you want to make sure you disable everything except your microphone auxiliary audio device 1. So just keep 1 sound source and just disable all the others. So for the speakers and shit, disable that. And for the
is
device
it the same
2,
Indian guy from that one video I linked?
Oh yes, yeah, this is the exact same video. Oh shoot, I didn't even realize that. Silly me. Oh, how did that audio, like, that I was just playing sound, though? How was that?
I had it muted because of the echo.
Oh, dear.
I have the live stream muted right now, just so I can actually hear you guys here.
Uh-huh.
I hear both.
I have the live stream muted, too, so I can't hear how it sounds. Because, I mean, if all of us, like, I feel like if all of us have it, like... going at the same time is just going to create an endless echo that's just going to, like, kill anyone who hears it.
Let me deafen Discord so I can try hearing the actual live stream.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's true. If you turn down Discord, like, for you, that might help. Or, like, I don't know. Doobie-doobie-doo.
Sound quality is not really that bad. It's just the echoing on me and Shade.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so the echo's like... Okay. Your audio still seems kind of bad. Okay. I'm going to unmute it for me and see how it sounds. Moist. I'm going to unmute it for me and see how it sounds. Moist. Well, at least my voice sounds fine. Alright then. How's that sounding for you guys? Not bad?
You sound fine.
Okay. Let's see, does your voice sound fine in the stream?
Nope, super echo.
Aw, jeez. That is absolutely terrible.
I still hear the echo.
Ah.
You don't have your speakers on, do you?
Oh, mine? Oh, shoot, let me, go to... Oh, what is it? It's an audio, right? Settings, audio, disable the speakers, right? Desktop audio device.
I mean, like, if you have any speakers, like, on your desk or anything.
Oh, speakers on my desk? No, it's just the one that I have plugged into my computer. Or, like, built into it. Channel.
Is it playing noise outside your headphones?
I don't actually have my headphones plugged in at all.
Try putting your headphones on and listening to it that way.
I can't believe I didn't think of that. Actually, I can totally believe I didn't think of that, because as we've previously established, I have no idea how this stupid streaming thing is supposed to work.
I think what's happening is your microphone is picking up the audio from your speaker and it's playing it back through your speakers again, and it's that's
probably
right.
All right, how about now?
Testing.
Let me see.
That sounds better.
Better? Less crunchy, yeah. Less deep fried?
Exactly.
Okay, well, that is very good to hear. Okay, so let's see, I can hear you just fine. Shade, give me something.
Yeah, that seems good.
Oh, that sounds nice and crisp. At least for me. And on the stream, it sounds fine?
Yep.
Oh, wonderful.
I say meet the ball.
All right, that is exactly what I want to hear. Okay, we've made progress. This is wonderful. This was 100% a team effort. I could not have done this without you. Okay, now for the...
Take a bow.
Uh-huh. Thank you very much. I do appreciate your help. All right, now... The actual important bit, we actually do a little test of the video to see how everything is going, to see if, like, the video doesn't come out too deep fried. I'm going to try and keep the audio fairly low anyway, because otherwise you can't hear our lovely, lovely voices.
So, Mr.,
It's probably going to be a few... If we're watching the videos via your live stream, it's probably going to be delayed for us.
Okay. So what we're probably going to do is just, like, give comments and, like, wait until the video is actually over to, like, give our thoughts on it.
There's also this website called Watch Together.
Yeah, it sounds good. The video quality.
The video quality sounds good? Okay, wonderful. Yeah. Sorry, Shade, what was that again? Watch Together?
Let me find it.
Okay.
Yeah, it'll play it simultaneously for all three of us, and I think all three of us can pause it too.
Really? I had no idea that was even a thing.
Yeah, I think I ended up using that for the 5-year anniversary stream I did a few years ago. There we go.
Okay. Watch.
Because then it won't delay the audio by like 30 seconds for everyone or for us too.
Okay. Watch Together. Why am I only seeing a white screen? Load. Okay. So, create a room?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's been a while since I've used this, so...
Create a room. What the hell am I even watching?
What?
Okay, so, invite friends?
I think you can... There's, like, a link or something. Or... You press the invite friends button, it gives you a link that you can send to.
That would make sense.
Okay. Copy that link. And put it in the old serverino.
Serverino.
The serverino.
Hey, that worked.
Yes.
Ew. Oh, alright, wonderful.
Pip, pip, tally-ho.
Whee!
We probably insulted a bunch of British people.
Yeetus fetus, commit self-deletus. Okay, perfect. Search or paste link to YouTube. Amazon. Oh, okay. Now what do I do? I can just
write in our handy dandy notebook.
What now?
Let me see.
Beatsteaks, Gentleman of the Year.
I have literally no idea what that even is supposed to be. That's just what showed up.
Yeah, I guess if you like get the link and then post it.
Hey, how about that?
Whoa! Wonderful! Oh my god, that orchestral music blaring right in my ears! Jeez, turn the audio way, way down. Holy crap.
That
I mean,
not holy.
I like Gravity Hurts, but not that much. That was loud as
schnishtix.
Okay, so I'm watching the Bionicle Battles Collab video itself, so that's nice. So
that bar at the top, if you just paste a URL to a video up there, it'll explain it.
Ah, perfect.
It like creates a queue.
Okay, so what I need to do is get the link to that playlist of all the collab entries, and that should do the trick, I think.
That might work.
Sure. I don't know why it wouldn't.
Compilation video, and then put the extra ones that you wanted to throw in as well.
I would think like if he adds like the playlist video, then when the one video is done, that would just go to the next one.
I think that's how that's supposed to work.
If the playlist link will be compatible or not, but I don't know. Give it a try.
Okay.
Right, and let's see. It seems like there's a full screen option. Didn't realize that when I did my collab.
It's in setting. It's in the little settings thingy. Interesting.
Yeah, you have to hit click on the gear.
Or you can double click.
Metal Gear.
Never played an MGS game.
I actually never played one myself, but that's beside the point. Okay.
Same here.
Never got around.
Snake
I'm
is
just,
funny, though.
I'm honestly not really a fan of shooters in general, is the thing, so...
It's more of a stealth game anyway.
Yeah, that's true. Wait. Start.
I own the latest game, but I haven't, played it yet.
So, Mr., I'm sorry, how do you pronounce your name again?
That's the chat room.
Oh, wrong one, my bad. Yeah, so like... Okay, so...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, what I'm trying to do is to get the actual playlist of all the entries I have, which is all just like in one convenient little place to play on the Watch Together thing.
Yeah, if you see the thing above the video on the Watch Together screen, I think that's where you need to paste the URL. The text box above the video.
The one with the little YouTube icon on it?
Yeah.
Okay. The Bionicle Battles Collab entries. Copy link address.
Man. I forgot about this. I looked it up. In Metal Gear 2, there are poisonous Zanzibar hamsters.
Amazing.
This is one of those series that goes back and forth between being incredibly serious and emotional to being incredibly stupid.
That is Hideo Kojima for you. Yeah.
Well, it looks like it worked on your stream, but I don't see the videos in mine. On my.
Not seen it. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I have a whole list right here. Okay, you're seeing that?
Yeah, I'm seeing that.
Ooh, wonderful. Okay.
Yeah. Are we seeing?
I don't see the queue, but if it works, that works.
Okay, so on the stream right now, you're actually seeing Shade's entry, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, on the stream. Well, hold on. Okay, now I'm seeing it. It's incredibly delayed.
Yeah, there's gonna be anywhere between like a there's going to be like a 5 or 6 second delay. It's probably like time zones. I don't think we can really do anything about that. I wouldn't worry about it too much.
All right. Before we begin, I think we need to make sure like we can actually get the audio from the actual videos playing on the live stream.
Okay. So I'm going to turn up the volume, go full screen.
I'm going to listen to the stream for a second.
Yeah. What the? Why does it keep pausing? Watcheth theeth helleth. What is going on here? Is this supposed to happen?
Alright, I can hear the audio. It was a bit lower, but yeah, I could hear it.
Uh-huh. So, okay, I'm trying to click on the video and it's freezing literally every second. I have no idea what that's all about.
I'm sorry. How do you pronounce your name again?
What the?
I don't know why it keeps pausing.
That is really, really weird.
Doesn't seem to be pausing for me.
Well, it's pausing for me, so I can't actually see it.
I see it pausing on the screen. I don't know why, or on the stream.
Uh-huh. Well, yeah, that's the problem I'm worried about, because, like, if it's pausing and all jittery and stuff on the stream, then it's just going to look weird.
Yeah, you might have to turn the video up on the stream a bit, because I can barely hear it through the stream audio.
Uh-huh. Well, I didn't want to keep the audio too high, but it's pausing again. What the hell? It's not even buffering. It's just randomly pausing.
I'm sorry. How do you pronounce your name again?
Weird.
This is, in fact, very weird. Okay, so if the watch together thing doesn't end up working, we might end up just going back to YouTube and watching it there.
Thank you. So I'm looking at your resume, and I do see some good stuff here. That being said, most of it has to do with guarding caravans. I don't exactly see a correlation between that and working in a circus. What can you bring to the table?
I mean, things don't seem to be... I'm watching a live stream and things don't seem to be pausing.
This is perfect!
Okay, well, for me, the video isn't randomly stopping anymore. I'm not touching anything. Okay. I'm just gonna let the video play for a minute or two longer to see how everything works.
Right, and then we can actually begin the stream.
In a few minutes, once we make sure everything's working properly, yeah. Oh yeah, one thing I also need to do, get on my phone so I can see the comments and whatnot. Don't need it.
Well, they already asked you all the questions yesterday. Why, are they gonna ask me and Wombat questions?
Of course they are! That's literally the whole reason you're here. It's like, it's not just me. Also, if I do all the talking this time, like, it is going to fry my vocal cords. Like, I was talking for 3 hours straight yesterday.
Yeah, that didn't look like fun.
I mean, it was fun, don't get me wrong. It's just, after doing all that talking for such a long time, my voice was fried. Oh, the stream sounds just fine on my end. I'm just playing it on my phone right now. Give me a second.
Oh, okay.
Whoa, hang on. Please, we don't need to fight. How about we show them here nice pop gun roll instead?
Alright, nice, nice. There's like a 1 or 2 second delay on my phone, but I hear everything just fine, so that is a good sign. Okay. Alright, so how was the past 2 minutes? Like, no interruptions, audio sounded fine and everything?
I wasn't listening to it for the past 2 minutes, but from what I have heard, it's been good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
The actual video audio, like, through the stream is a little quiet, though. You might have to turn it up, but...
Well, okay. A little bit too quiet?
Yeah, from the video itself.
the video. So the video that's playing on screen is a little bit quiet. Like I said, I don't want it turned all the way up because like it doesn't need to.
Definitely not.
Yeah, it's supposed to be pretty quiet so you can just watch the video, but like we're going to be talking over it, so I don't want it to be all that loud. Otherwise, it'll get cluttered.
I'm gonna run to the bathroom real quick. So.
All right, cool. You run to the bathroom. I need to get a drink of water so I stay nice and hydrated, so my vocal cords don't fly out of my throat and run for the hills to escape all the abuse. Okay. All right. Let's take a break. See you all guys here again in a minute.
3, 2, 1, break. Alright, I'm back.
Welcome back. Alright, I've been back. Alright.
We gotta get this live stream off of private.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, well, I can do that in a second.
You might actually want to just close it and restart it, since we spent the last 30 minutes troubleshooting on the live.
I don't think... So if it's private, I don't think it actually... saves it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so what'll happen is that, like, once it goes public, everyone will see the live stream from, like, the moment it goes public. It doesn't, like, wind back.
I'm talking, like, if someone watches it after the stream's over, they're gonna see, like, 40 minutes of us messing.
Maybe.
That is if you're going to keep it up on your channel afterwards, which I'm assuming you are.
Probably. I mean, yeah, I'm probably going to... I can just cut it out, like, in my video editor. It's not a huge deal. Okay. Yeah, all right. Let's start again from the beginning. All right. Yeah, so I think I'm going to go to... What I think I'm going to do is just control things from my phone and then just let all the videos play on my computer screen.
Here's a question. If you got the screen open on the browser like this, does that mean anyone watching the stream can join the Watch Together queue?
I didn't think about that.
If we keep it full screen, I don't think it'll matter.
Yeah, I'm gonna keep it full screen.
Right, it's still unlisted right now.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah. Well, the viewers are only going to be able to see what's on the screen. That is a good question, actually.
Yeah. If you were to tab out or something, and then I don't know, because the only thing I mean, I'm not really worried about our audiences, you know, doing anything to the stream, but.
Yes. I mean, I don't know about your subscribers. I don't know about your subscribers, but I know for a fact I have at least 5 or 6 members of Al Qaeda that are subscribed to me, so that might cause some problems.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
Jay Willikers.
Ew, no. This is
a jeez, Rick.
Oh, jeez, Rick! Okay. Yeah, no, I don't think it's gonna be a problem. I'm just gonna, like, set it to, friggin' that. Hmm. started streaming 23 minutes ago. Well, I mean, if people want to, they can just watch me go around and, like, fiddle with my PC like an idiot, but I don't think people are going to do that. Besides, it should just go live, like, from the moment I make it public. Oh, that's actually something I need to figure out, is if it just automatically goes to the next one.
I think it should.
Yeah, but I just want to double check to see if it does.
Okay.
Because if it doesn't, that would be an unfortunate oversight. Ew, nice little skip-ahead feature. That's nice. Oh!
So, Shade, how much do you pay your mocks to be your mocks?
How much do I pay? I'm not sure.
You don't know how much you pay your own employees? Disgraceful. Shade, you friggin' disgrace.
$15 an hour, I guess?
Holy crap.
That's
a full-time job.
That's actually, that's pretty good.
It's above minimum wage. I would expect most actors to get more than that.
Uh-huh. I don't know like the exact ways actors are paid. So,
How much time off do they get? And do they get vacation days or sick days?
Well, given how half of the cast don't even show up that often.
Once you get a default. Okay, so for some reason it doesn't automatically go from one video to the other. I don't think that's a huge deal. I can just, go to the next one. I don't think you can actually join this unless I send you, we send people a link. Yeah, no, I have to actually click invite friends in order for that to work. So,
okay.
Yeah. Gotcha. So, you have to, give other people the link to the actual room in order for them to join, so I don't think that's going to be a problem with the off chance one of our subscribers decides to be weird and, invade the watch together thing. Uh-huh. In the off chance that does happen, I will throw them into the ocean. Don't worry about it. All right. Well, if we think we have everything ready to go, I guess we might as well just get make the live stream public. And if everything goes wrong, oh geez, Rick, I'm getting stage fright.
This is my first ever live experience.
I mean, if it makes you feel any better, this is only my second, and my first one was kind of a disaster, so we're all more or less in the same boat.
People made memes out of it. I doubt it's 100% a disaster.
It's not. It's only been one day since I did my first live stream, and, it's already become a meme. That, last night was crazy. You should have seen it. Okay.
Who else did? I know Leoplorodon did.
Leoplorodon and Grax did one.
Grax,
and
I don't think
There might be other people who did it that I just wasn't subscribed to, so I didn't see it. So, yeah. Alright, without further ado, let's get this ridiculous-ass live stream I have in mind started.
Only an hour late.
It's only been, yeah, pretty much. All right.
As far as troubleshooting goes, that's actually pretty fast.
As far as troubleshooting goes for something that none of us really have a lot of experience in, that is actually not bad, no.
Wait, yeah, really? I might ask you for some tips later.
Let me do five or six more live streams and figure out how to actually not make a complete fool of myself. And, I will be more than happy to give you some tips.
I've taken making a complete fool of myself and embraced it.
I mean, yeah, me too, but, if it's on purpose, then obviously, I want to make a fool of myself. If it's accidentally making a huge fool of myself, then it's a different story, then it's not as fun.
It's not as fun for you, but it's even more fun for everyone else.
Yeah, of course.
I'm going to spread the link around to some of the other servers I'm in.
Yes, whore me out. Let it make it so that everyone can see us.
Spread the love.
What was that? Was that supposed to be a burp or something?
No, it is not supposed to be either of those things.
Oh, calm down, Edgelord. Jesus Christ. Top chat 4. Where is everyone? I did make this thing public, right?
I see 5 watching now.
Oh, I see 6 people watching. I'm gonna see if...
I see 5 people watching. Somebody just left.
What? Get the hell back here! Do you have any idea how much work we went through setting this stupid thing up?
It's been 3,000 years.
Get back here.
Our plan has been 5,000 years in the making, and you're not even paying attention to us?
Someone else just left.
Oof.
Five watching now, although one of them is probably me.
You drawn micros, nobody commented it? No, you are, you're literally the only one here. Hi.
I'm Batman.
Hello there.
I'm Mediamac. Oh, now people are showing up. Took you guys long enough. Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm probably gonna get this thing, like, actually rolling.
We should probably explain to people what we plan on doing.
Yes, Shade, by all means, please pick up some of the slack because I can't talk very much because my... Oh god, my voice is already starting to go. This is horrible.
Well, Mac wanted to bring us all together so we can watch all the various entries in the Bionicle Battles Collab, both those that got accepted and those that did not quite make the mark, just so we can give our thoughts on them, what we liked, what we didn't like, and etc. And plus just all the random insanity that comes from 3 doofuses hanging out together. Besides, I think this is the first time the 3 of us are actually speaking to each other verbally.
Yes, that is actually true. This is the first time the 3 of us have actually done, anything together at the same time. So this ought to be neat. Oh,
yeah,
7 people watching.
Yeah, and I've known Mac for like 5-6 years now. And it's just now.
You could say we've brought together a group of remarkable people.
You call us remarkable?
Damn! All right, so I guess we all know what Shade's opinion of us is now. That's pretty savage.
Oof.
That is one heck of an oof right there. Okay.
Trust me, I have a bigger sarcastic wit than most people expect.
Yes, you can be sarcastic if you want to. I have noticed that before. Okay, RM Studios.
Oh god.
For those of you who weren't aware, in last night's stream I did an impression of a dying Visorak, and not even a day later it has already become a meme. So don't expect me to do that this stream, because I would probably spit out my vocal cords and they would like fly, all my entrails would like fly over my computer screen, and I don't want to get them dirty.
Not to mention this live stream will probably be demonetized if you're even making money off of it, which I doubt.
Probably not. Because I'm using so much third-party stuff in this video, it's highly, highly unlikely I'm going to be making any money off of it. Who cares? I make enough money selling crack on the side to make ends meet. Pretend you didn't hear that.
Wait, you can make money off of YouTube?
Not anymore.
Very true.
Yeah, YouTube, we totally need changes, like not being able to see the accurate, only seeing abbreviated subscriber count, unless you actually go into the creator studios. Seriously, if you had made actual real necessary changes, maybe we would hate you.
Hello?
Hello?
That was weird.
Yeah.
RM Studios, yep, I made the meme with a godly no! Oh, that's wonderful to hear.
Nope.
No. Yeah, so there was the Dine Vizorak, and then I also, some dude asked if I could, I was building a Lego set, and some dude asked if he could see the progress I was making on the set, and I just really loudly and really angrily said, no! And everyone was just, it startled everyone. It was hilarious. RM Studios. Hey, Mac, any advice for a stop-motion series? Refer to what I just said 10 seconds ago for my reply to that.
No.
Correct. Grax the Wanderer, what's up, dude? Man, here for two live streams in a row. Good to hear you don't have any life either. It's alright, we're all in the same boat.
Grax is back.
Mm-hmm. 10 people watching. Met Productions, I can't stay for long. All right then, Met, because I have several of your, all of your entries actually lined up in the stream, so in, if that is the case, we should probably get this real soon. Met Productions will be here until 8-ish. You're, okay. Like, what time is it for you guys, Wombat Shade? It's like 5 for you, right?
It's 5 for me.
It's a little after 6 for me.
Okay. I think Met's in the same time zone as you guys, so we should definitely be able to get to his, things pretty soon. I'm gonna see how I have everything lined up real quick, because I have these things in order. Okay, so it goes his... Yeah, we should get to his pretty quickly. Just to, like, start the stream off, we're gonna go over our three entries. We probably aren't gonna spend too long on them. And then we can just move to other people's.
Don't spend too long. We've had a single image on a lemur holding a resume for the past several minutes now.
Yeah, well, but people have been hearing our dulcet voices, so that's better than any video.
She's reading it very thoroughly.
Grax Wonder, it's 1:07 a.m. But whatever. Look, when you have no life, you don't need to sleep. We all know this.
Well, I've been awake since 4 a.m.
Well, and he's also from Mother Russia, so...
From Mother Russia! Okay, you know what? Let's just get this ball rolling and start reviewing all these videos. I think the format I wanted was we each give one thing we liked about the entry and then one thing we think that could be improved. And then
one thing we absolutely hated.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, it's like, well, God, this mock made me so angry, I hate it, it's stupid!
Well, Met Productions, if you aren't able to make it by then, you still have a live stream archive, so even if you can't make it...
Yeah, I'm probably going to upload this, like, the full thing to my channel later, so you can just, like, look through it, like,
you'll be able to come back to it. Well, like, if you have it as a live stream, it's going to stay up there anyways.
Exactly. Okay, so, let's get started, shall we?
I'm ready.
So, Mr. I'm sorry. How do you pronounce your name again? Thank you.
I just like how on the resume is the only thing that's a readable word, a language. Everything else is just scribble.
Yeah. I think I mentioned this in your mock review for Baje, but why does the Chinese pigman sound Australian?
I guess I was just trying to sound...
You know, kind of gruff, but I guess it kind of sounded Australian as well.
I mean, yeah, sure, why not?
A lot of my voices sound Australian. Some people have commented that Jaller sounds Australian.
What he sounded like was kind of a weirdish Cockney accent, almost in a few parts. Yeah, but overall, you did a really good job voicing Jaller.
Oh, thank you.
Uh-huh. How have you not included him in one of your videos yet? That's crazy.
Why didn't I write resume and Matoran letters? I guess so the audience can actually see it. Like, not everyone knows the Matoran language front and back. Also, but mostly I just didn't think of that.
Edgy sounds.
Well, I wasn't sure if I was going to voice him. I was considering like getting someone else to voice him, but in the end, I guess I just figured letting me do it.
That is an oof and a half right there.
I already kind of went through the trouble of like, I originally want Thatchmack to voice Rinolo here, but he rejected. I did get Lena Valatraz to voice Adelie, but all that took a while to take care of, and I guess I didn't want to go through more of the trouble.
Ah, yes, Lena is a good choice.
Yeah.
Med Productions, bye-bye! Alright, come back later once I upload the stream to my channel and you can check it out.
Bye, Met Productions.
Bye-bye! Oof. Yeah, Baiji is unexpectedly scary, like when he actually starts fighting.
But when you're a giant pig man.
A giant pig man with friggin' pyrokinesis, that is scary as hell.
And a very sharp break.
GG no re, his hammer is weird. I am fairly sure that's supposed to be a rake.
Yeah, it's based upon the it's based upon the character from Journey of the West, Baje. And he uses the rake. It's not really supposed to have 9 prongs, but if I actually did that in Lego form, it would be way too wide.
It'd be too thick. The thickness would be too much to handle.
Grax, to answer your question, I guess it's just like so we can see everything. The blue guy, Silara, it's a girl.
What's going on here?
Voiced by my sister.
That high pitch, though.
I don't care who shot first. This was a mess. Everyone who participated in this battle now has to pay Renola and Nala for damages, which will come out of your paychecks.
I'm a hard-nosed boss.
Damn, Shade. You a savage.
But I didn't even start. I've kind of made comparisons between like this and the Muppet Show, where I'm basically Kermit, just trying to get everything together.
Man, they are 100% gonna go to HR over this. That's the whole thing, I believe.
It's a Bionicle Battles Collab with a very special guest. Everybody, yay!
Okay, so, let's see. Who wants to go first with one thing they liked about that one?
Well, if I gave one thing I liked about my old video, then I'd be a bit too biased and narcissistic, wouldn't it?
Oh, yes, fair enough. Okay, I'll start then. Let's see. One thing I liked... Excellent command of the scene overall. I think the reason yours went first was because it had like a really good balance of like action and humor, which most of the other ones like pretty much just focus on one over the other. So that was pretty cool.
I have to give credit to you for the actual idea behind the setup.
Yes, you did in fact get the idea from me, which is surprising, but whatever. And then, like, having multiple characters actually fighting was also cool. I like that. Let's see. Things that could be improved. What did I tell you? If there isn't at least one bar stool being broken over someone's head, then it's not a real bar fight. I mentioned this to you multiple times, and it didn't happen in the video. Boo! Shade, you friggin' disgrace!
Why, thank you.
Okay, Wombat, you have any thoughts you would like to give on that video?
Well, let me think for a second. I think what Max said about having a lot of characters fighting at the same time, it does definitely add a lot more action to the fight scene, and definitely is a lot easier to animate multiple fight scenes at the same time, because you don't have to animate the entire fight scene from start to finish with the two characters and have like a cohesive start to finish. So it creates a lot more action and it makes it more intense.
Oh, thank you. I think my logic was like, it's a bar, there's gonna be multiple people here, so why not have them get in the fight? I also tried going for like characters with multiple different fighting styles. Like, you saw guns, you saw blasters, you saw swords, I mean, if they were all just sword users, then it would get a little less interesting, you know?
Right, exactly. And the different... I agree on that. I like the part... I don't really know the names of all your characters, but the female, I'm assuming, Toa of Water?
An elemental queen of water. It's kind of like a precursor to the Toa.
I gotcha. She made the water blade, and that effect is pretty cool.
Thanks.
And I guess one thing that could use improvement, I feel like your voice acting kind of has very high level. The levels of your voice acting volume shift quite a lot. So sometimes you have to turn up the volume to hear the voices, and then next thing you know, your ears bleeding.
I guess that makes sense. I think the logic in my head was, like, people are going to be louder and quieter depending on what they say or the emotions.
True. It's just, you know, overall the video is better to watch when everything stays on sort of the same volume. You can still have the same different levels of voice, I guess, impedance? Is that the word for it? I don't know.
I get it.
That's just my honest view. Mm-hmm.
Okay, Shade, you're allowed to talk about your own video if you want to.
I mean,
defend yourself.
We already have a lot.
Put him up, sucker.
We already have a lot of videos to go through, so we might as well move on, anyways.
I mean, yeah, if you want to, that's perfectly fine. That is true. For the rest of these, we're probably going to have to keep them a lot more concise, so we'll be able to get through all of them at a decent pace. Wombat Combat, here is yours.
Oh, no.
What do you mean, oh, no? Yours was one of the best.
Oh, no.
I don't like being put under the spotlight.
One of the best? It was probably the best.
In my opinion, it tied for the best with Mason's Mox. Both of them were very, very good.
I personally think Toa of Ultimate Dooms is one of the best.
Oh, his was really good too, yeah.
I had 25 minutes on my end.
The video's not playing for me.
Yeah,
it isn't?
Not me either. Yeah, not me either.
You can see it on the stream though, right?
I can see it on the stream.
Oh, that's weird.
Let me refresh on my side.
Alright.
Hello, the watching relic and Grax the Wanderer.
Oh yes, let me take a look at the chat. I feed on moss. Yes, moss, the healthiest type of fungus.
Nom 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 nom.
Bionicle-saurus is up. Hey! This time you didn't miss a stream, Bionicle-saurus. Awesome. Okay.
Yeah, it's still not playing over at the Watch Together for me.
Oh god, yeah, why is it... Here. Why do I have just a white screen on mine? Oh, because I paused it.
Did you pause it?
I paused it by accident, that's why. That makes sense.
And now it's playing on my end.
Ah, I'm an idiot. Oh, jeez. Productions, thank you for inspiring me to make animation. Which one of us? There's three of us here, I don't know which one of us you're talking about.
Probably you, since you're the one in charge of this live stream.
Noxus. I mean, okay.
As a diversion, an elaborate stalling tactic, if you will.
An elaborate stalling tactic, if you will.
Moss is a plant, not a fungus. That's semantics.
Wait, moss is a plant? I thought it was a fungus.
What even are plants?
How could plants be real if our eyes aren't real?
What are birds? I just don't know.
I'll take you down just like any other threat. A living organism of the kind exemplified by trees, shrubs, herbs.
Shut up, nerd!
Oh, come on, I like doing this show. We're just read off the little definition. Useless. Noxus is OP. Nintendo, please nerd.
Shouldn't you abandon the? If you want to talk about OP, then the female Toa with the ability to manipulate quantum mechanics is kind of...
Oh, that's her power? Sense of humor. That's ridiculous.
Well, literally anything you can call a barrier, she can control.
Oh. Okay, then.
Theoretically, you could say she could control the barrier between life and death and just kill you.
So it's not just anything that could be considered a barrier. Anything she interprets as a barrier, she can manipulate? Yeah, that's crazy.
Mistress and I can understand this burden.
That's why all her attacks are like these little square things, because they're little barrier attack card things. I don't really know what to call them. Knife.
Are you sure you had enough knives?
You know, after I made this video, I went on Bricklink and ordered 90 knife pieces.
Are you sure that was enough? Oops,
sorry. I think I have enough now.
Can she manipulate emotional barriers?
The moment I guess so, probably.
That's disturbing.
She can make you sad. Or happy.
Joke's on her, I'm already sad.
I thought it was
gonna be another ginger joke. Oof. Anime intensifies. Are you guys actually able to watch the video right now?
I'm seeing it just fine.
I still can't see it.
Oh, it's still messed up for you? Okay. Well, that is
I'm watching it on the stream.
Oof. Okay. Alright. Who wants to go? Wants to go first?
Boy, you probably made the most anime stop motion I've ever seen. 10 out of 10.
That would make sense.
Let's see. One thing I really liked about it. Dude, the effects on this one were friggin' amazing. How long did it take you to do all that stuff?
I had a few sleepless nights of, staying up late and editing that. And I think I probably spend just as much time editing this video as I did animating it and stuff.
That makes sense. Yeah, that does make sense. That leads into my next point. One thing that I think could have been improved, there were a lot of frames where they were just completely, still and things were happening in the background, but, the animation could have been a little bit smoother, if you ask me, throw in a little bit more frames, but that is a pretty minor complaint considering, how good the video is otherwise.
I do agree with that.
Uh-huh.
Entirely.
Yeah. Yeah, still frames aren't necessarily the best unless they're, really, really artistic.
I'm not confident enough in my animation skills at this point to attempt a full frame animation where there's no still frame.
I mean, this is pretty good, so you're already off to a really good start. Okay,
I just don't animate in full frames because I don't know how long it's going to take for, all the dialogue stuff. You would have to plan all that ahead of time.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, let's move on to mine.
Oh, boy. Hey, I can see it now.
Oh, wonderful. Growl. Crunch. Mine was definitely the... No, wait, actually, I was about to say mine was the crunchiest, but I think Toe of Ultimate Dooms actually had more crunch sound effects than this one, I just remembered.
Yeah, exactly. Stupid resistance.
Oh, man. Doing Vizok's voice messed up my vocal cords so bad. Thank goodness Vampra doesn't actually speak canonically, otherwise this fight would have been horrible to voice over. Bionicle Saurus. Yes, the signature Beatty Mac sounds.
Well, even if Vampra did talk, you just do his voice first. Save the harder voices for later.
Uh-huh.
Or you do one on a different day.
Oh, I love that little come beckoning. At me. It's like, what, come
would,
at me,
would
bro.
Would Vampire even do that type of thing?
I don't know. I don't can't really recall how he was actually characterized, like, in the books, so I just did my own thing here.
Yeah, the only characterization I got is that he was just quiet and a hunter. That's really it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so this one, he's quiet and, pretty friggin' mean. I mean, damn.
He's a Makuta, of course he's mean.
Uh-huh. Like, look at that, he's just shutting him down.
I love that part where they're grappling and he's smacking his side.
Uh-huh. Oh yeah, that was a cool bit right there. My favorite part of the fight is coming up in a few seconds. My personal favorite part.
Pew! Oh, the yeet?
Uh-huh. Give it a second. Leoplerodon, yo-yo, what's cracking? You made it to another stream.
You're the last person I would expect to hear yo-yo from.
That was my favorite part of the fight, where V-Zog just yeets a corpse right at Vampra. Honestly, it's the best attack.
I think the only thing that would have made it better is if we actually play the yeet sound effect over it.
It's like the one line Vampra has in the entire series. Or sorry. Oh, wait, no, it wasn't. It was V-Zog speed. V-Zog just goes, yeet!
No, not even just V-Zog saying it. Just play the sound effect in general.
This guy's dead. Yeet.
Oof. All right. What did you guys think of that one?
I do like how the fight kind of transitioned all over the place. Like, it got a fist fight at one point, then it transitioned to weapons. It made sure that things didn't get boring.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and in classic Maniamax style, the fight scenes have very, very large amounts of weight to them and are extremely, what's the word for it? Carnal? I don't know.
Cool. Yeah, like, when, especially, like, when Vampra was, like, hitting V-Zog, I wanted to, like, give the sense that, like, if you're, like, when you're getting punched by him, like, that would hurt.
They're actually, like, struggling in the fight with each other. It's not just them dancing with each other.
Yeah, I mean, Vampra thrashed V-Zog pretty hard, but it was not a one-sided fight. Like, V-Zog got a lot of hits in, especially that part where he was, like, punching him in the ribs.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, it's David. It's been a while.
Zerax Lord Sentinel, very fluid motions, a nice camera motion. Thank you, I worked really hard on this one. Okay, things I liked about it. Both of the people in the fight were bad guys. They were blue, and their name started with a V.
Oh my god, I'd never even noticed that.
Uh-huh.
Vampro versus Riza.
Yes.
Nardozi wants to ask, how the heck do you animate on carpet?
You use telekinesis. That's how I animate all of my stuff. I don't use my hands. You'll learn how to do it eventually if you practice. Okay, things that I would have improved. I don't think I put enough effort into the effects. I should have used, like, I could have put more effort into, like, the eye beams and, like, the blood and shadow and stuff, I think.
I think the effects were actually pretty decent.
Mm-hmm.
I think... Mac, what you really need to work on, out of anything you actually do need to work on, it's set design.
Set design?
Yeah, you need some kind of background that's not your bedroom.
Yeah, that is a good point. I do have, I'm working on a green screen right now, actually, but I didn't have it set up when I was filming this. So, oh well.
Yeah, I always feel like having almost no background is better than having a bedroom as a background just because of the distraction, but I do realize personally
how hard
it is to animate Bionicle in anything.
Yeah, this is not an ideal. Yeah, this is not an ideal setup I have right now, but that is absolutely a fair point. Shade, what do you think?
Well, regarding backgrounds, at least I guess I kind of have the excuse with, like, I'm directing these guys, so...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Shade's got the fourth wall break, so it doesn't matter where he puts his mind.
That's true. Bionicle Source, especially when the end of HOV had surprisingly great set design. This feels like kind of a backtrack. Well, that was literally just in my basement that I just embellished with some, like, background materials, but I did try to give it, like, an underground sort of industrial look for, like, the ZIS places and whatnot, and Zynthronia in general. But yeah, anyway, moving on.
Oh, shoot, Borok321's here. Welcome.
Oh, seriously? Yo, Borok, what's up, dude? Who needs set design? I do, clearly, according to Wombat. Okay.
I say that my set was literally a green screen, a cloth, and Bionicle canisters, so, I mean...
Yeah.
I think the hardest thing with the green screen is, like, trying to do multiple angles.
Oh, yeah, camera angles with green screen sucks. I have no idea how to do it.
I mean, I think when Noah Productions did Nation 2, he, like, commissioned people to help with that.
Did he? Hmm.
Yeah, he got a 3D model maker. I think it was Joe something or other.
Joe Smith,
yeah, that's what it was. And he actually modeled a fully modeled Mari Nui and like the seafloor and all that.
Oh, we got something now that's not from the collab, that didn't make it into the full collab.
Yeah, this is the first one that didn't make it in. This is the Rescue Part 1 by Baraki124. So let's see what this is.
Oh boy.
I think I recognize that icon from a few of the comments on my videos.
Yeah, so I've seen most of these, like, at least once. But, yeah, there's, like, a lot that didn't make them in. Almost half of them.
Hey, I recognize that torso design on that mock.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Blah, 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 blah. No.
You will die. Oh, yep. Why am I getting CDI Ganon vibes? Oh, I think I saw a hand.
Oh, yeah, no. If I saw a hand in any of the entries, then, like, they just didn't make it in, I'm pretty sure.
I mean, sometimes I make that mistake myself.
Uh-huh. Oh, there's the hand again. Well, yeah, like, if it's a mistake and you can cover it up, that's one thing. But, like, if it's the first thing you notice, then that's a problem. Leoplerodon, tell me about it. It's especially hard when I animate the backgrounds afterwards. Yeah, that sounds rough. Leave the mouse to be safe immediately.
I do not know. I can tell that a Baraki here, English is not his first language.
Yeah, you are probably right. So, what's something that you liked about it?
Well, I think I'll start with this one. That green and white mock seems very close to one of my mocks, Kanpaku, the half-ghost descent.
Really? Interesting. Yeah, I have not seen all of your mock review videos, so I would not know. I promise I will go and watch some of them afterwards.
No, that's fine.
You're right, Borok. Those were random characters.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that is one thing I kind of like. There were a lot of characters in this fight, so there was, like, a lot going on.
I think I was just kind of confused. I mean, maybe it was because, like, I'm also listening to you two, but I'm not sure if I really got what was going on, to be honest.
Yeah.
It was a little tough to follow.
Yeah, animation was also, like, really inconsistent. Too many still frames. Like, I counted, like, so many frames where there was just, like, nothing happening. So, like, there wasn't a whole lot of, like, flow and pace to it. So, yeah, this one didn't make it in for, I think, reasons we have adequately explained. All right, on to the next one.
Baraki, if you end up seeing this, then there's always a chance you can always get in next time.
Yeah, no, this isn't for the purpose of, like, saying, look at all these losers that didn't get into their club. No, this is literally for the purpose of, like, giving constructive criticism and stuff, because... There were some that, like, I just didn't include in the collab, and then there were others that came really, really close and were just, like, barely edged out, like, at the last minute by others that, like, I couldn't not include, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. Okay, so next up is that guy over 9's entry, Bionicle Battle Colbies.
Oh, so this is one of those, like, video editor apps, I'm guessing.
Uh-huh, yeah, that was another thing that, like, I usually kind of got turned off of. I saw, like, in little if I saw, like, the name of the app it was used for, but I don't know. If the animation was good, let's see.
Is that a doctor? That guy's an interesting design.
These mocks actually are pretty cool looking, yeah.
I agree.
I know, they're custom.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this one's actually pretty good.
Wait, was that part of the... did part of that sword fly away?
Did it? Oh, saw a hand.
Part of his hand got cut off.
Yeah, that's the second time I saw a hand.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Med Productions. Oh, hello, welcome back. Did you do mine already? No, yours are coming up. Wii Video. Okay.
Sponsored by Web Video.
Okay, so Wii Video. if I can praise anything besides mocks, I did notice some more interesting techniques here, like a laser blast being a lightsaber boot that was just animated upward, and there was some neat stuff like that. It kind of reminded me of with Toa Scarrock's videos, how he used certain effects, like he would use a Makuta Shadow Leech core as a fireball and stuff like that.
Yeah. I actually like the animation. Like, it was surprisingly consistent, like, pretty much the whole way through, so that was nice.
Yeah, I think the choreography was... the fight choreography was pretty good. It's just the actual... the way it turned out in the end, mm-hmm. with the techniques used to animate it. It probably could be improved, but that's just with experience, I think, animating.
Med Productions, how long? Just be patient. We'll get into yours pretty... how many more of these until we get to Mets? Because he's, like, asking me about this. Not too many more. Like, 5 or 6, I think. Try not to spend too long on each one. Let's see. What held back for me is... I'm actually having trouble to, like, actually, like, directly criticize about this. The choreography was decent, but, like, the movements were a little bit too stiff for me to, like, actually... for me to, like, sell it. Like, there wasn't really a whole lot of impact to the hits and whatnot, if you ask me.
Also hands.
Yeah, I saw a hand in the video that,
I saw two.
Uh-huh, yeah, that definitely... my impression's 20 minutes at the most, I think. We're getting through these pretty quickly.
Should we just, like, skip over and see his, and then we go back to the original position?
I mean, yeah, sure, why not? Like, we can do that. We'll skip ahead. Leoplerodon, when's yours coming up? Never.
Oof.
And then sad music plays.
All around me are familiar faces. Places.
No, I was thinking more of the Lonely Man from The Incredible Hulk.
I actually don't know what that song is like.
I just want to politely roast Maniac here for a second.
Let me find
out. With all the flaws of that last one's animation, he actually did have a cardboard box as a...
oh, that hurts.
Alright, here's...
I don't know what I was expecting, but it wasn't that. Oh. Alright, Met Productions. I decided to skip ahead and show yours early because I guess you are busy with something. Okay, so... So Matt actually sent me in 4 entries that they didn't get in, but we're going to show Reinarth vs. Greinarth from Met Productions real quick.
Oh boy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this guy looks real familiar. Where have I seen him before? This dude looks familiar too. I can't quite put my finger on where I've seen them before.
I'm just hearing My Hero Academia. I break that up in any way, and Mac, you're probably bound to cream your pants.
I think you're recognizing that that mock from Flandrick.
Is that Drazen's son?
I was going to say Azario. Azario versus Drazen.
Lol, no one remembers who Azario is.
But I remember. I actually kind of liked him.
Nobody remembers Azario. Nobody.
comment section, do you remember Azario?
The correct answer is no! Bionicle Sword is yes, it's obviously Flandrix. Yes, you are probably correct.
Flandrix, canonically, is the mother of Drazen.
Yeah, sure, why not? Azario lost his GF and he was super sad, OMG. Top 10 saddest anime moments.
Okay, I'm seeing some repeating frames here.
Really? Honest, I'm seeing a still frame with paint effects. Okay.
I mean, I see what Matt was trying to do here, but I get... It feels kind of stiff, and it, the sound effects don't really have the crunch to them, like the aurora sound. I appreciate the attempt, Matt, but it could have been a lot better. Like, even moving, like...
Yeah, like this right here. So it's like, why would you include these paint effects instead of actually showing them punching? Like, there. That was good. I actually liked that. Why didn't you do that for the whole fight? It came off as kind of lazy to me.
I mean, do a combination of both. Do the arms moving and the paint. At least then it would have looked a bit more convincing.
Oh yeah, both of them together would have actually looked rather good. I don't know what meant why you didn't do that, because that would have actually looked nice.
Okay, what's the point of the break?
Whoa, loud.
Huh, I wonder why I've seen that before.
My arm is damaged. Didn't your mother warn you about what would happen if you did that?
Oh, jeez. Dying Visorak noises. Oh, God. Sudden orchestral boom at the end.
Okay, I guess I know what that's not Drazen signed. Since I guess this is based off My Hero Academia, I guess that's All Might and Deku. That's what I'm getting. Yes. I don't watch a lot of anime, so I wouldn't.
All Might and Deku if they were his mains, I guess.
I have not watched My Hero yet, so I did not get
you of all people, the biggest weeb out of the three of us, haven't watched My Hero Academia. What the hell?
On JoJo.
Oof.
No, you'll have to bring up Toho. Then that'll get Wombat to cream his pants.
Ooh.
Ooh, good one.
Toho is not an anime, though.
No, I wouldn't be surprised if it got an anime adaptation.
It has some anime adaptations. But
what, a Godzilla anime? There is one.
Oh, not very. Oh, no, not the Godzilla anime movies. Please, no.
Okay. I mean, I haven't seen them, so I can't say if they're good or not.
Anyways, okay, thoughts on the video? I've kind of already given mine. I mean, I appreciate some of the ideas and the attempts, but the execution just could have been better all around.
Mm-hmm.
Drawn Toho is not an anime. You are wrong.
Yeah. So...
Knifed.
Yeah, I think this is the only one for Matt I'm going to show. Like, you can go to his channel to watch the rest of them if you want to.
I mean, we'll probably get to them eventually.
Yeah, sure. You know what? We can do one more of his, because he sent in four. We can show one more of his.
They're all unique fight scenes?
Yeah. Well, three of them are.
You have a mock named Eugene.
His name is Eugene? That is a new one. I'll give you that. Met
okay,
production.
I don't know what mine's racing to more. Eugene from Tangled or Eugene from Adventures in Odyssey? Adventures in Odyssey.
Yeah, so this is another scene from My Hero Academia. It's based off of the hero exams from season 2. Met Productions. Okay, well, look, Met, we have a lot of these to get through, so we cannot spend too much time on one person.
Nazani, Nardozzi, we'll get to yours eventually. Don't worry.
Nardozzi, yeah, yours will come along sooner or later. Just stick around.
I admire his determination.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's a determined dude, but, like, it's just your animation skills. He needs work.
I mean, to be fair, I think he's newer to the scene, and it took me a bit for my animation to him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is very true.
Doing animation with the figures themselves, it doesn't actually look too bad.
Yeah, you're right.
The last scene when he was showing the same two frames or the still frames with just the paint effects, he could have just as easily done like two frame animation and it would still look.
Yeah, that is a good point. Yeah, so what I liked about that one, the little bit of action we saw like right there in the middle. was pretty good. I thought that was pretty well executed. Actually had some nice weight to him, which is something you don't always see. So that's cool. Things that could be improved. This is true for, I think, every single entry you sent me, Matt. You need to actually, like, work harder on the animation. Like, this half of this one was just them, like, talking. And then there was, like, maybe 30 seconds of actual fighting. Matt Patterson, sorry if I'm so needy. Look, none of us are perfect. We all have areas where you can improve. You specifically, you are actually not half bad at animating. The bits of animation that I did see, I actually quite liked. So for the future, I would actually recommend you double down and do more actual animation instead of just showing still frames or like them standing around and talking when they could be fighting. That is what I would recommend to you.
I know so, yeah. one thing that kind of caught me off guard was like after the fight, it just showed like shot with the character names above them. That was kind of jarring, I'll be honest.
A little bit. Introductions, thanks, Mac. You are welcome. Cyber Dumbmaster, I love all of BioTube. Y'all are amazing. Aw, thank you. That warms the cold black hole in my chest where my heart used to be.
And you are all amazing as well.
Uh-huh. Oh, wow, 45 people everyone. Watching.
I swear I sounded gay at that point.
Gay! Okay, let's watch this next one.
Hey, won't deny I'm far from the manliest man out there. I'm still straight, though.
Oh, whoa, what's this?
Wombat, what the hell did you just say?
Nothing?
Yeah, that's right.
Made with Kind Master. Okay, so it's another app editor.
Yeah, this is that's probably one of the reasons why I didn't get in. Just throwing that out there right now.
You're bisexual?
That is some janky-ass walking animation right there.
Did I just see a, like, wire for him dropping?
Did he just Naruto run?
I think so.
Matsunui's shoulders are on backwards. I kinda am bothered by
it's over, bitch.
Alright, 10 out of 10.
Is it just me or the sound effects don't exactly line up with, like, when they actually hit each other?
Borough, if you're drawing wire is better than hand at least. Can't argue that with that. That is true. Can't argue with that.
Is this?
To be continued, question mark. Absolutely not.
Was okay. that an original piano piece playing in the background then?
I couldn't tell you. So, right off the bat, one thing I liked, voice acting 10 out of 10. Absolutely flawless. That was brilliant.
Was that even voice acting, or is it just like an audio clip?
I don't even care. Either way, it was amazing. Let's see. Things that could fix. Right off the bat, the camera angles were really, really weird. Like, I think it was on a tripod the whole time instead of, like, actually being up close to the mocks as they were punching each other.
Not to mention, it's pretty blurry.
Like, oh, yeah. Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, it needs, like, a focus. Even if it's like a manual audio or auto, I prefer manual, just something to actually focus on the mocks. Of course, maybe the camera's just old. It could always be that.
That's probably true, yeah. I think this was on like an older camera.
Yeah, for some reason I'm getting vibes for from like Scott TGG's like old videos, just with better, more animation.
That could have been just an Android camera as well. I know.
Yeah.
I have an Android, and my Android camera sucks in quality. Yeah. So
you drawn micros. This one could have been from 2009. Yeah, this felt like something from 2009. If this had been from 2009, it would actually be quite good. But it wasn't. So yeah, this was one of the better ones I didn't get in. Sorry, what?
I'm actually remembering. Like, I brought up Scotch. When you actually think about it, his fight scenes are. Yeah, quite garbo, because there was barely any animation to the fight scenes.
Oh, yeah, no, he had barely any fight scenes, like...
It was more talking than anything.
It was almost completely... It wasn't even talking, it was literally just text on the screen describing what was happening.
And, like, falling over to the ground with, like, using the video camera, like...
Grex Wanderer, Lel, my camera's 15 years old. What? Your camera's older than some of the people watching this stream, dude!
Doesn't seem like a 15-year-old camera.
Yeah, your picture quality for yours was actually halfway decent. Okay, this one is from Sykes. I think that's how you pronounce that. So let's...
Sykes.
This is one of the shorter ones. I also... The shorter ones are the ones also ones I didn't typically think about too much, but... Okay, yeah, let's see what we got. Second.
And already pretty low frame rate.
Mm-hmm. Meep199 had literally just animate using my phone and a tripod. Lots of people do. What?
Yo, what? Barracks just does a dive bomb.
That twist ending, though.
Also, Janice, what are you doing in my video? that guy legit looks like one of my Glatorian mocks. He has the same helmet and a similar weapon.
Does he? Could
just be a coincidence, but...
Interesting. Let's see.
I don't really know what to say about that video.
Yeah, okay, so Sykes, I seem to recall he told me he spent 2 months working on this. I don't believe that for a second, honestly. His frame rate was really, really low.
Not to mention, it seemed like to be only one shot.
Yeah, like...
Right. I mean, unless he, like, found a way to, like, keep the camera still while he took out, like... While he took out, like, the files. Mm-hmm. Or he did, like, something like Dragon Frame or something like that. I don't know what it's called. Where you basically where it automatically transfers to your computer.
Mm-hmm. X250 Productions, friggin' Barracks. I did like that, the little twist ending with Barracks showed up. That was funny.
I will say it's better than some of my first stop motion animations, even mm-hmm. with like voice acting and camera quality and everything.
I can kind of tell that this was made by someone younger, not a lot of experience.
Well, as if the voice wasn't a dead giveaway.
Right.
Well, of course. But I guess it does definitely give room for a lot of improvement in the future.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. So, here's one from Solek, the best Bionicle set. Actually, I need to go to the bathroom real quick, so Wombat, Shade, this is all on you guys.
Oh no.
Should we pause the video?
Let's pause the video. This is Max Stream. Let's let him be the man.
How the heck did it take 2 months to make this? I have no flipping clue.
Okay, everyone, impromptu Q&A sessions. Let's ask all the questions you don't want Mac to answer, and we'll answer them. Or all the embarrassing questions Mac would answer.
Yes, guys, mayonnaise is an instrument. I didn't even watch SpongeBob. My parents thought it was too inappropriate when I was a kid.
Well, hello, Watching Relic / Bionicle Sword. I was actually browsing his alternate channel the other day, and I didn't even realize he had an alternate channel where he reviewed dinosaur toys, and it has like 30,000 subscribers or something.
Holy shoot.
Yeah, Watching Relic is more popular than all of us.
Oh, hey, Tech. Didn't expect to see you here.
What did I miss?
Not much.
You missed absolutely nothing. Except tentacles.
I missed tentacles?
Yeah, there's tentacles now.
Hmm. What do the tentacles do?
No anti-allowed here.
Then I'm not interested. On to the next one.
Cyber Nubmaster wants to know what is both of our biggest mocks.
Well, we already know what my biggest one is.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Played a Nintendo Switch.
Yeah, he's big enough to hold and use a Nintendo Switch like a human being. So, yeah, he is big enough. He is a big boy.
I want to say, for me, Kagarok. Unfortunately, it's to the detriment. I can't even really stand him properly.
Mm-hmm. I said I would make a tutorial on how to build Titan mocks like a long time ago, and I never got around to it because I'm lazy and I never follow through on my promises, but I don't know. I think I'll do that soon, if I can.
Is Max secretly a Visorak?
I think we need to hear it die real quick to see if that...
Oh god, don't make me do it again, please!
gun. I'll grab the sword.
You'll gain up on him.
Oh, God.
It'll be a lot of fun.
Wait, hold on. I think you skipped. We didn't watch that last video.
Hmm? Oh, they were all from the same dude.
Kuro versus Mercury.
Kuro versus Mercury? Which one? Where?
The one with the tentacles.
That was literally the one we just watched, wasn't it?
We paused it as he left, so we didn't.
Oh, we didn't actually watch it? I didn't know that. I thought you just watched it without me.
Nope.
Oh, well, why didn't you tell me?
Know it was obvious.
Oh, nothing personal, kid.
Quality voice acting. Is that Mega Man music?
I don't know.
Bit.
You're gonna pay for that Buster. You're gonna pay for that Buster. Oh my God. Purple Boy, is this gonna get uploaded later? Probably. Get that sweet, sweet, delicious ad revenue. Just kidding. There's no way this video is getting monetized. Guess you want to play rough. Oh my.
He just got shot, and he just said, guess you want to play rough, huh?
I mean, I don't know what kind of foreplay you're into, but I'm not into getting shot. That's just
guy stole Kazuck's hat.
Right?
Oh, you're right. That is just straight up just a knockoff of Kazuck's hat right there.
I think it's upside down, but still.
And the original didn't have a gear.
Right. If we're nitpicking, then that's true.
Yeah, I swear this is Mega Man music. I swear. 16-13, Magic just crazily unfair. Unfortunately, I just put you down.
I like that sound effect. I think I might use that in one of my videos.
Let's see. The voice acting was That's it, Buster. Oh, great unintentional comedy right there.
I found the video kind of hard to follow, but I think that also kind of adds to like things being generally slow and the voice is kind of
definitely too slow.
Pacing, yeah, was pretty bad, and I think with the voice acting, it almost seemed like he went like the final video. It didn't look like he understood how to edit the video in such a way so that the sound effects and like the actions did not happen at the same time as the voice acting.
I am almost certain he made that on his phone.
You know what the voice acting reminds me of? It's like when you're at your parents' house and you're trying not, and it's late at night and you're trying not to wake them.
You know what? That actually makes way too much sense. Okay, Nardozzi Productions, site clean right room. I don't care.
I have experience with that.
Mm-hmm. Trust me. I think we all had. When I lived with my parents, I had to work around that, or at least tell them, hey, I'm going to be loud. So
my family was out of the house pretty frequently, so I could scream my lungs out to my heart's content.
Yeah, my dad works from home, so I usually had to deal with him.
Yeah, and now I live alone, so I can basically scream like a dying Visorak, with the only caveat being if I scream too loud for too long, someone is 100% going to call the police.
Lol, I live out in the way.
Tectonic Films, Maniac is a small bipedal creature running through his walls. He knows this and he won't admit it. We deserve the truth, damn it. I don't know what the hell you're talking about. That is obviously just completely made up.
Who needs voices? Yeah, you're right. We'll just mime everything.
Nardozzi Productions is an oppressed gamer. Whatever, I don't care. Okay, on to Creeper Dude 302's entry. This one did make it into the final collab. I actually really like this one, personally. It was one of the better ones, if you ask me.
The one to escape his nightmares. He must conquer his demons.
Tahu versus Jack.
Yeah.
What's Jack? Jack in the Box?
Probably. I mean, I'm guessing that's what that character is supposed to be.
Oh, I'm referring to Jack in the Box, the fast food place.
Yeah, that place is honestly scarier, if you're asking me.
So, I've been thinking about this video a lot.
Oh, really?
And, yeah, I love the mocks in this video. They're very edgy and very, very cool, very hot topic.
Oh, man, this is one of the edgiest ones I've received, and that is saying a lot.
Yes, but I think the main drawback of this video is the fact that, A, there's no sound effects.
I think I saw a hand.
It's one solid track of music.
Yeah.
Which could work if he edited it a bit more like it was a music video almost.
Yeah, definitely.
That worked a lot better.
You are definitely right. What held it back a little bit for me was the audio. There wasn't enough punching sound effects or like that kind of thing. Also, no.
That's okay for dubstep.
It does kind of detract from the action a bit when you can't when the animation's a little rougher, like when they're teleporting and stuff. I guess they're teleporting. I don't really know what. Which is a problem because there's no sound effects.
Yeah. Yeah, there's almost no effects, period. No sound effects, no, like, paint effects. Not even any paint effects. It's just, like, filters.
Yeah.
Benjamin J. Blon, hey, Maniamac, what was the worst mock you've ever seen? I probably don't remember it. Because if it was bad, then I probably didn't pay attention to it.
You can just consider this video a music video then. Maybe, but then I would expect the animation to match with the audio. Like have each of the action beats go with like the musical beats.
Oh yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah, I kind of like the way they edit trailers now, or that goes along with the song.
Right, or heck, even Fantasia.
Right. The actual, like, animation is pretty smooth and pretty consistent. Like, he doesn't make a lot of mistakes.
That is true. There was one or two times where I saw his hand, but I was willing to let it slide.
Suspension of disbelief.
A little bit.
Right, and stuff like a black screen, like, what showed up for a few seconds, that was kind of jarring, to be honest. The entire thing is a bit slow in places.
Yeah,
I agree with that.
Yeah. Grax the Wanderer, it was a pretty stylish video and nice entry. Yes, so while there are definitely parts of this entry that could have been better, like, the atmosphere, like, was really, really good, in my opinion. The music and the atmosphere and, like, the filters used really set the scene well. And then the actual animation, like, it had a few issues, but overall it was pretty good. I quite liked this entry, even if there were a few things I would personally have fixed.
Yeah, it's definitely one of the better ones.
Mm-hmm.
All American Rejects are back, and this is their newest music video. Good one, Tech. Good one.
Mm-hmm. Oh my god!
This is one of my favorites. This was like the funniest entry like I received easily. This one was hilarious.
So where the last one got edginess right, this one got comedy right.
Oh yeah. So, Edgiest Rockshi by Legend Weaver 25.
Which is funny, because Edgiest is in the title of this one.
Yeah, this one has edgy in the title, and it's not even edgy, it's just funny. Well, it's edgy, but it's like ironically edgy. Or unironically edgy. It'll make sense in a minute.
Yeah, this unironically reminds me of Biorock Dude's video.
Yeah, I'm definitely getting Biorock Dude vibes from this video. As if the Rockshi heads weren't a dead giveaway.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, except the yellow one sounds more like SpongeBob than
That is, you're absolutely right. It's like, is that SpongeBob as a Rockshi? That's hilarious.
Yeah, Legend Weaver, how did you get Tom Kenny to voice this?
Dude must be stacked. God damn. Oh, God.
Oh my God, he's so edgy he killed Vampra and he's wearing his mask on his back.
Damn, that's edgy. He's wearing Vampra's head on his ass. There's no... Man, that is incredibly edgy right there.
It's butt armor.
Oh, he threw a motorcycle, just like Zeri's did in that one Fight for Emerald episode.
Why is the tail wide when... other than its claws, the rest... Okay, I guess there's wide on the leg.
Video footage!
To be honest,
this is actually the original version that was from his channel. The version he sent me, I told him to cut those parts out. There were a few entries that I made people edit so they would actually fit the rules. So for this...
mine was one of them.
Yeah, so Shade, I made yours cut out the video camera. This guy, Legend Weaver, I told him to cut out the video camera parts. Right, that's it. So that version is the one you saw in the actual video.
Nothing personal, kid.
Yeah, there was another video that didn't actually fit the time limit. It was too long, so I told him to cut some parts out, which is a damn shame, because the animation was actually pretty good, but we'll get to that one later.
I didn't even take out the video parts. I just disguised it to make it look like stop motion.
Oof. He deceived you.
Unironically?
Lord Shadow.
I was laughing for like a solid minute for this part. Oh my god, that was hilarious.
After the recent Sonic Twitter takeover from a few days ago, in hindsight, I think that Shadow quote is actually funnier, given some of the things we learned about him from that Twitter takeover.
Yep.
Apparently Shadow actually gives a lot to charities and likes cute kittens.
Interesting.
Yeah, that's canon now.
Interesting. Yeet! See
it.
Shade2800, you did a good job with the carrying and your series. I loved it. Wow, good for you, Shade.
Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you very much.
They liked your stuff.
What kind of DNA lets regrow? Oh, see you, Tech.
Okay, bye-bye. Yeah, probably.
We're up to almost 60 people watching this stream.
Oh, shoot, you're right. Holy shoot, as Shade would say. God, if you're gonna swear, just actually use swear words. What the hell?
I rarely swear in real life. If I usually swear, it's usually like under my breath or if I'm really, really angry. And if I swear when I'm angry, then you know who I'm really angry about something.
I refuse to swear on the internet.
I personally get offended when people don't swear, so whatever.
Hey, just use alternative.
Meep 199. Holy frick. Hey, I have limits too, you know. You keep up with inappropriate language like that, I am 100% banning you. Meep, I'm watching you, boy. Okay.
I remember that pun.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so things I like. This entry was so funny. It was hilarious.
The animation, man. And the camera angles moving around. Like, that's something that's so hard to do, getting the camera moving in stop motion. I feel like that's one of the best things.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, very true. Yudramako's a Shade. Heck. Yudron, I'm going to find you. I'm going to yeet you into the sun.
Yeah, heck you too, you fart knocker. Shut the front door.
Leo Pluridon, but I will make an exception. We're going to say the end. Ooh. All right. Okay.
It's an Australian song. You know, it's well enough.
Jeez. Okay. Yeah, so let's see. The only thing I didn't like about this one was the video camera, but I made him take that part out in order to actually get into the collab itself. So,
If I'll be honest, I think the Legend Weaver's mocks, they could stand for some improvement. Like, sometimes I feel like... they don't feel cohesive enough. Sometimes the color schemes is a bit too muddled. That's more of the mocks and less of the video.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Leo Pluridon 2000, no comma. Hey, that's racist!
I don't really take Rakshi head mocks seriously anymore, to be honest.
Me neither. That's why you don't see my own self mock very much nowadays. Okay, on to the next one. Turbo versus Gunner from Purple Boy. This one was pretty good.
Purple Boy.
Oh, you're a fan, are you?
He's actually, unironically, one of my favorite mockists.
Oh, really? His mocks are really good, yeah.
Yeah, that's our guy.
Wait, are the eyes painted or something? I just noticed that.
Yeah, I noticed that too. It's like, is that a paint effect, or did you actually switch that out on the mocks themselves, Purple Boy?
Ender Boy, you are correct. Flendrix did indeed used to have a Rakshi head, but she wears a mask. Did
I get him? I don't know, did you? Say again, sweetie. Ugh, so condescending. Oh, God. That's cringy right there. Oh, no, he committed self-deletus.
Dead.
No big surprise.
It's 2019 and people are still using that? What?
So, since Purple Boy's in the chat, I'm a little confused about what the little counter thing on his back is. Can you explain?
Oh, yeah, Purple Boy. Mind explaining that to us?
Yeah, especially since I think I went to the same place. As both times.
I mean, maybe he's, like, charging up an energy blast or something.
This guy!
We just need a sound effect.
Oh, apparently the eyes are a piece of paper behind the visor. That's
no way! You actually, like, put a piece of paper with the eye? That's impressive! Like, I thought that was a painted effect.
In a lot of his mocks. He does a lot of customization.
That's crazy!
Paper all over.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay, so, things I liked about this entry. The mocks are really, really good. They have a really unique style to them, and, man, the whole actually using paper behind the eyes in order to get the facial expressions. Dude, getting facial expressions on mocks is one of the hardest things to do, and you actually figure out a way to do it without using painted effects. That is really, really impressive. Like, man, I need to watch more of your videos after this. That was really good.
He explodes if it reaches 5.
Oh, okay.
Weird. That seems like a really weird weakness to have, but okay.
Does it charge automatically, or does he have to charge it? This feels weird.
Why are you a penis cupcake, Leoplerodon? Why?
A penis? Creeper Biotube Sarker. What is this biz? It is me reviewing all of the Bionicle Battles Collab entries, including the ones that
here.
Oh, God! Who summoned Creepy Biotube Stalker?
I think he invited himself in.
I sure as hell didn't invite him. Okay, Purple Boy, things I would have improved about this one, too many still frames. Like, there were too many scenes where, like, the characters are just, like, standing around, not actually fighting.
Yeah, it felt a little slow in places.
Yep.
Yeah, his mocks are obviously really good. And I like the character of his mocks as well, or the character in his mocks as well. He should work on his animation a little bit more though.
Mm-hmm. The animation,
I mean, there's nothing like outwardly bad about the animation. It just, you know, could use improvement.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, my main issue with the animation is that he didn't do enough of it. Like the few bits I saw were actually pretty good. It's just you need to like you know implement more of it. Okay, on to the next one we have... Oh, Nardozi, are you still here? Because this one is the one you sent me. This is one of the ones that almost made it in, but got replaced at the last minute.
What is the funniest thing you have thought, Maniamac?
The funniest thing I have thought? It's whatever it is, it's not appropriate for me to say, in the presence of my subscribers, who
you
I know
dare are... strike a wizard?
That was literally a reference to a really obscure Thor comic from, like, 2009. So, like, yeah. Let's see.
Still fun.
Yeah, okay, so Nardozi Productions, he just called it Bionicle Battles Collab. He didn't even come up with a title for it. That's...
Oh, hey, Zarek.
Mm-hmm. All right. I don't know. Oh, hey!
From Spidey's animations.
Oh, that's who he's supposed to be? That makes sense.
Yeah,
except
with less Play-Doh.
Alright, I immediately rate this a 0 because I saw that thing in the background a sec.
Hey, it's Zerk Playfield. What the? Oh, yeah, I just saw it too.
Reminds me when I've accidentally had my sister in the background of my shots and some of my older stuff.
What?
What? There's just random frames of people cut into this.
Uh-huh. And suddenly it got really, really dark. And it's over.
Oh yeah, okay. It just cuts off.
This one's just kind of confusing.
Uh-huh. Yeah, you're right. There wasn't really a whole lot of consistency to it. Or like, no real, like, logical sequence of events.
I would just say, Creepy Bot, Tube Stalker, if you didn't have enough material with the original collab, you'll probably have more than enough here.
Oh boy. Yeah, you're welcome. Feel free to use all these free open source memes. That said, the few bits of choreography I did see, even though they were kind of choppy, they're pretty decent. Had some nice action going on there, and Zarek's always nice to see. We all love him, obviously.
Also, try animating from stuff that doesn't reflect nearly as easily.
Oh yeah, you're right. That is something else he could have fixed.
I mean, that's the mistake I've fallen for with, especially with some of my older stuff.
No Noisy Productions, I had recently no time at all. Well, okay, everyone had 4 whole months to work on their stuff, so like I felt like I was a generous enough time window, but yours wasn't bad. It's just I would have like tried to like orchestrate or execute it a little bit better, and then like it could have gone on longer instead of just randomly cutting off. But yours was not bad. I actually kind of liked it. Even if there were some parts I would have personally changed about it. Okay, let's go to Fight for Overworld. Huh, I wonder who this dude was inspired by.
So it's Endworld crossed with Overwatch.
Oh, God. So
I'd actually watch that.
Yep. Fight for Overworld by his 3.
Nah, give me Pharah instead.
I'm already Pharah.
Or Symmetra.
I'm already Symmetra.
Okay, Torbjorn.
I'm already Torbjorn.
Fine, I'll grab someone who's not even in the game.
Nerf Bastion!
Incorrect.
I'll grab Pootus Man.
Your argument is invalid.
You just straight up pimp slapped that dude. That was hilarious.
Journey once again into the breach.
Coming this summer. Red NC-17.
This summer.
Okay, can we please have a different? Can we at least have some? It took like how many? Like 20 seconds for there to be actual animation there.
A little bit.
Not so threatening when you're on your back, are you?
Oh my.
Eva, when did you steal Axon's hands?
Personally, I find if I see someone laying on their back, they're even more threatened.
Uh-huh.
Okay, buddy. Time for a beatdown.
Okay, buddy.
Okay then, buddy. Time for a beatdown.
Cool.
I'm glad you finally decided to hit me. I thought this wasn't going to be very interesting.
He's too strong. I can't fight him head on. I'll get beat every time. I have to be fast. Keep
it. Zarek versus Deadpool. Yeah, that does sound good.
People have been asking that for years. Hey, just spam Ryan Reynolds about it. Maybe he'll decide to do something about it. Oh, that sounded like a thwomp from Mario. Yeah, me too. I saw that. Oh, and the music just stops.
Music cuts off.
Oh, how the tables have turned. Alright, tell me,
where's the rest of your team? It's Noxus Brando.
Oh, holy crap, you're right. It is. Oh, looks like I wasn't the only one who got inspiration from there, Wombat.
Nah, it's... I got inspiration from that.
Oh, hey. I wonder who this is.
Actually, no, I don't
see. Oh, he literally just says he's Drazen in the video.
Oh,
right in the kidney. That's horrible.
Okay, that could have been framed better. Like, the second shot, it should have, like, flowed better.
Oh, then it ended kind of abruptly. I mean, so the animation was a little bit inconsistent for me.
There's a lot to take apart here.
Yeah. The bits of choreography I did see, though, were actually pretty nice. It's just I wish they would have had better, like, sound effects and whatnot.
It was dramatic, I can say that.
Yeah, Brennan Vilcek, man, Drazen lost weight. He didn't just lose weight, he lost 2 whole feet. Like, he shrank.
I feel like I'm...
That was a talk war if I've ever seen one.
I feel like I'm missing a lot of backstory going on in this video, and it doesn't really work to the video's favor for a new viewer, but...
Yeah, that sounds about right. So, yeah, it was, yeah, okay, but, like, there are some things holding it back. That's why I didn't make it into the actual collab. Oh, here's one that did make it into the collab. Cyan versus Shiurix, I think I'm pronouncing it right. Oh, my God. That is one thick mock right there. Holy crap. Rex Wanderer, oh, my God, I can't wait to be roasted by Biotube Stalker.
Oh, wait a minute. Isn't that white one, one of the winners of Thatch Max mock contest.
Oh, is it? I didn't know that.
Actually, I think so. I rewatched the results video earlier today. So.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Oh, Zion Illusionist, if you're watching, this is yours. That did make it into the collab.
I do really like the mocks in this video.
Oh yeah, the mocks are very fantastic. Nice. You're right. Those are some nice mocks. Extra thick.
Yep. Okay, is he flying there? I couldn't really tell.
It looks like he's just sliding across the floor.
Yeah. But his feet were not touching the ground, and there was like transparent brick, so I'm thinking he was flying backwards. And I think that thing on his back's a jetpack or something.
I think you're right.
That's SpongeBob music.
I was like, why is it playing SpongeBob music?
Okay, now this is extra thick.
That's
thick thighs. That.
You're talking to a man who appreciates a thickness, so.
Uh-huh. Okay, so if that part of the SpongeBob song had been synced to her landing on his head, that would have been perfect. But it wasn't, so I'm going to have to take points off for that one. Aside from that, like, I like the animation for the most part. The choreography was pretty nice. But that camera shake was terrible. Oh, my God. Like, what was going on there?
I guess that's the issue when you're trying to do, like, moving camera work. And mm-hmm. You don't exactly have one of the professional tools for a moving camera.
Well, all you need to do is put it on top of, like, a book or a box or something and just slide it around. But what might have also been...
Like, back when I was gaining an associate, they showed us some of the tools that they use. They have, like, the sliders where you hook a camera up to. So, if you try to replicate something like that, unless you have a tool like that, I could see how it could come across as a bit choppy.
I think he's probably using, like, a pocket camera, like, quick snap fun camera, almost, for this. Because, the animation's pretty decent, but with the camera shake, I'm pretty sure he's taking pictures with the capture picture button on the camera.
Mm. Okay.
With the not 1080p as well shape of the video, like it's not in the right aspect ratio, so it could be an older
camera. Yeah, you might be right.
Neoplore with orange. She puts Mammoth to shame. Oh, I think it's thicker. She definitely has a more noticeable gut.
I didn't understand a single thing you just said, Shade.
What just happened to your audio? That was weird.
Me? Never mind.
You turned it into a microwave oven for a second.
That was weird.
Transformer rollout. Transforms into a microwave oven. reheats some leftover meatloaf.
Ew, who actually enjoys meatloaf unironically? That's weird.
Hey, my mother makes a pretty... darn good meat. I just can't make it as good as her.
I'll take your word for it. Okay, so this is Andrew Usabi's entry, The Dragon Hunter. I liked this one. This was one of, like, the last-minute ones I got sent, but this was a pretty good one.
This one was fantastic.
Is it just me, or did it remind me of that one boss fight from Dark Souls where you fight that giant wolf?
The giant what?
The giant wolf.
What, like Sif? This is, a little bit.
I don't know. I know if it just bring up Dark Souls, you'll cream your pants.
Oh yeah, anyone who like references Dark Souls will like instantly has my attention if they do that in their series. It's like Dark Souls? Well, you had my curiosity, but now you have my attention. Man,
so, I'm guessing this is the only entry that had a non-bipedal character in the.
I think you are right. This is the only one that showed like a large monster in it.
Unless you count the thick mock from the last one.
Mm.
Oof.
Blaze Warrior 1 and 2. I would love to see a Bionicle Artorias. Oh man, me too. That would be badass.
Artorias?
Yeah, okay. You know what? Friggin' Rocka's head from like 2011, the lion one, really looks a lot like Ornstein's helm. So I feel like someone could probably make a good Ornstein mock if they felt like it.
Let me see if somebody has tried.
I've been told that my mock Malice, the puppeteer, looks a lot like Artoria. Which I didn't know who that was until they commented that. I don't play Dark Souls.
Oh, I found some. Oh, I did find something. Here, I'll post it in the Discord chat.
Oh, okay. I'll take a look at it later. Creepy Box says that dragon is a toothless. I mean, it literally doesn't have any teeth.
Also found this.
Actually found it kind of cute. And I cried when it died.
Yeah, so like, this is one thing I had. It's like, is it dead? Did you just leave it to like bleed out and die? That's terrible. Like, God, at least finish it off quickly and end its suffering. That's just wrong. Titanite. Oh, Titanite. I am going to make Ornstein now. Do it. Do it. Make him as thick as a Titanite slab.
So maybe we should talk about the video.
Well, we should talk about the video because that was very, very good. Thing I liked the most was the actual hits had a ton of impact to them. Like, the fact that he was using a hammer and you could hear the thwack noise and you actually saw the dragon recoil from it, that was really, really good.
I think I just like the atmosphere of the whole thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, you're right. There's some good atmosphere.
Yeah, you don't really need a lot of background or story to a video of a guy just fighting against a dragon that's trying to keep.
Mm-hmm.
A Durgan.
Yeah. One issue I had, and this isn't even necessarily an issue with the video itself, because I can't really think of anything off the top of my head that's wrong with it, but it's like...
Oh, maybe... I guess it could be a little slow at points. Also, saddest dog movie ever.
Oh, yeah, it's like... Dude, it's like, who am I supposed to root for in this fight? Because this dude just walks up on this innocent wild animal and just straight up murders it. It's like, damn. Did this dragon, like, kill someone? Does it, like, eat babies? It's like,
who's... Bingo ate my baby!
Yeah.
Is it Dark Souls that has a sword where you get health?
A couple, actually. The Butcher's Knife, if you use that and it hits enemies, it restores a little bit of your HP. The Server is a curved greatsword that also restores HP upon... hits. There's also Arstor's Spear in Dark Souls 3 that will restore a little bit of your HP if you kill a mob enemy. Those are the ones I can think of off the top of my head. Oh, there's also a couple swords that grant HP regen as well as part of like just an innate quality they have. Does that answer your question, Shade?
I mean, it wasn't my question. I was saying someone else's.
Oh, shoot. I didn't even see that. I haven't looked at the chat in a second.
I'm Meep199.
Meep.
Meep,
meep, meep, meep, meep. Okay, so that was a good one. So,
I really have nothing negative to say about that one.
Yeah, me neither. That was a really good one. Oh, shit! Here it is. It's Grax's.
AKA the most violent one.
Oh, yeah. This one was the most violent entry I received by a wide margin.
Yeah, kiddies, leave the room, especially if you have your parents around.
Rex the Wanderer. Oh, no! Oh, yes! Oh, yes. This was pretty ridiculous. A random dude with no life, this one was chill. I don't think you know what the word chill means.
This one reminds me of all those classic BioTube like mock spotlights where they show the mocks like killing everyone.
Oh yeah, that totally.
Looks like a BioRock dude mock.
Uh-huh. Oh, this is like old school BioRock dude like cranked up to 11.
Slay, queen.
Literally.
Okay, that thing literally reminds me of an old Transformers toy I used to have. I don't think I have it anymore.
I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be a turret from Portal, but I'm not 100% certain.
That's what that reminded me of. I feel like this video needed subtitles, though.
Yeah, the audio is for the voices is a bit too low. Kind of hard to understand them. Like, I get, Grax, you're Russian, right?
Leaked footage of Bayonetta 3. Good. Maybe if they all shot at it instead of standing there watching. Okay, good point, Stalker, good point.
Or talking about leaving.
Oof.
Knifed.
You're not going anywhere! Oh man, what a champ! He's still standing, but he has a knife through his spine and he got his arm cut off.
Yeah, I don't get what the point of this guy just saying, he's saying, help me, and the other guy just says, no.
It just reminds me of that one ASD movie skit. Help me, super guy! No. You're a jerk!
And then he immediately has to fight her one-on-one because he did not help.
I mean, to his credit, he does actually do some damage. But...
yeah, I think he takes her out, doesn't he? I mean, not kills her, but, like, incapacitates her.
It feels weird watching these videos at normal speed. I've been watching YouTube videos at, like, 2x speed for the last few months now.
I tried doing that at... oh my god, I almost died! How do you do that? That's crazy!
Well, I think it helps that I was watching that originally it was 1.5x speed. It helps me watch more videos in the same amount of time.
Was that Kylord?
Yeah, I was gonna say, is this Egyptian Anubis Kylord?
Anubis Kylord. That yeah, is his bit. New canon name.
Okay,
and then the little robot, the robot with the minigun has Dr. Scorpion X's.
Yeah, I think you're right.
That's a lot of damage. How about a little more?
Yo, we need to get some flex tape and put her back together.
Let's just bring Phil Swift.
To show you the power of flex tape, I sawed this woman in half.
You see a bloody chainsaw in the background.
That probably count as sexual assault.
Okay, so right off the bat, things I liked. So much violence. This was the unideal amount of violence. It was great.
Violence, 10 out of 10.
Uh-huh.
I think the walk cycles, like, it seemed a little off to me, at least. I'm not sure if anybody else noticed that.
You know what? Yeah, that's true. Like, the walking animations were a little bit janky in a few places.
Minimax's head is shaped like a soda cup?
What? Who said that?
Ivax the Awesome. Ivax the Awesome.
What the hell do you mean my head is shaped like a soda cup? That is, people have said some weird insulting things about me in the past, but that is that is a new one. What does that even mean?
It was Darius, then I remade it and kind of stole Kylord's head. It's coming from Grax himself.
I mean, it literally looks like Mirror Universe Kylord, but he's a cool mock, so I mean, I'm not the... I mean, I'm not going to hold that against you.
Anubis Kylord. That's his official name now.
Anubis Kylord. We have Kid Drazen and Anubis Kylord so far from mocks that are ripped off from other people. That's pretty neat. Okay.
I did think all the mocks in that video were pretty damn good.
Yeah, they were a bit basic, but there was a lot of thought into put into like each individual one.
They all have a pretty decent character to them.
That's something
I like about.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't really matter how well built they are or how complicated they are to me. If they look unique and they look like cool characters, I think they're cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's fair.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you don't need a really complex build to make like a good. To make a good mock. I remember being, I was doing a Chatting with Chums episode with Shadow11 and a couple of others, and we were talking about that. Like, not everyone has the parts, so you gotta make mm-hmm. In the end, it's all about the execution.
Yeah.
Grex the Wanderer, they were basically just there because I needed them to die. Well, they did their job beautifully, so for what they were, they worked out quite well. Okay, so
They were the expendable crew members.
They were all red shirts, basically. Alright, so here we have Kreush versus Agents by Mike2000. This one did not make it in. I don't remember too much about it. I think I might have seen it once.
That was actually kind of a decent flip.
Actually, the animation here is not that bad.
What are you doing, Mech?
What am I doing? Oh, shoot! That transforming weapon was... That was cool. Holy shit.
Cool so far.
Maybe this is one of the ones that almost made it in.
Oh, you know what? Yeah, this is... I think what happened was that this one got sent past the deadline, and I still took a look at it, but, like, the video was pretty much done. And that's why. Yeah, I think this is one of the ones that came, like, close to getting in, but didn't quite.
Is that the Sanctum Sanctorum in the background?
Is it?
I think so.
Or is that one of, like, the Lego City modulars?
Oh, it just ends.
Yeah, it did cut off a little bit abruptly, so,
Yeah, but that was actually really good.
That was not bad, yeah.
I feel like that should have made it in.
You know, this is the first one I've come across that I feel like you're right. I could have switched it out with, like, one of the other ones I put in, yeah. I don't know which one you would like to have me switch it out with, but, yeah, this was, mm-hmm. Yeah, this one was nice. I actually liked it. Yeah, I would have liked to see more sound effects.
That is true.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there wasn't too much, like, actual fight choreography, from what I saw. It was mostly just characters, like, running around and attacking each other, and then, like, running off camera, but this was good. Yeah, it was pretty good. This is the first one I have run into that I actually kind of regret not putting in, but oh well, there are others I have to get through.
I think he probably should have cleaned the Lego and the Mega Blocks out from the background before he started filming it, but...
I think he did that on purpose to have, like, set dressing, but whatever.
Maybe. It just kind of breaks the immersion.
A little bit. Okay, here's another one that didn't get in. Team Battle by Omega Nexus.
Yo.
That's a
3D printed Batera head, yeah.
Uh-huh. Oh, that's what those are? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I have one of those on one of my mocks as well.
Cool, cool. I don't actually have any of the 3D printed masks.
Neither do I.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, suddenly a sound effect?
Yeah, suddenly a sound effect. You know what? I remember this guy sent me his... Oh, yeah, now the aspect ratio is changing. So, like...
That's a little weird.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think I remember now. So, this was a late entry I received, and... What the hell was that? That was really weird. Yeah, I remember now. So, this was a late entry I received. I remember emailing him back saying, "Is like... Hey, resend this with the music added and then all the sound effects because it sounds like a lot of them were missing." And I guess he never bothered to include them, so that's probably why I didn't put it in. It's like he didn't really do anything with the audio. Like, when he did actually use the audio, it sounded out of place because the rest of the video was just silent.
Yeah, if you're gonna have a mostly silent video, just have the whole video silent and be more consistent at least.
Right. Give credit where it's due. I did like some of the paint job. I noticed some scars. I noticed some Day of the Dead style masks.
Uh-huh. Yeah, the customizations, the mocks, I think, were pretty cool.
The mocks themselves were not bad. Yeah, I actually did kind of like them, especially the Batera head one.
Oh yeah, that one was pretty cool. And I'm gonna skip back to the beginning here. That right there, the roar effect, mm-hmm. that looked pretty cool.
Yeah, if he'd actually included a sound effect, that would have been wonderful. But yeah, okay, let us move on to the Insultinator by Phantom. Now, this one was sent past the deadline because this is the only one I think that I haven't actually seen, so this will be new for all of us.
Neat.
Yeah, all I know is that it was sent past the deadline, which is why I didn't include it.
By the way, hi, Rigel.
Oh, Rigel, hello. How's it going? Yours will be coming up later at some point. I don't remember when. I don't remember what order these are in.
When this become WWE here?
Okay, so far it's just weird echoey talking, so that's not really... What?
What?
Okay. I love this entry.
Yeah, this is WWE.
This is the first time I have ever seen Duplo used in a Bionicle video like this.
That is not a trash can. That is something else.
That is a Minecraft creeper that's yellow.
Yeah, it's a creeper. Yeah, it's a creeper that gotta get bathed in pee.
Pretty much.
Wait, is this battle literally just a diss battle?
I think it is.
Kind of reminds me of when Med Productions, I think he did a rap battle with one of his entries.
He did, and we are not going to go over that one because it was weird, and I didn't like it. Rip. Ow, my ears!
I think I went deaf.
These sound like Shade2800 insults.
Hey, I think my insults are better than that.
Oof.
Oof. Don't stand on that.
Oh, video camera. Okay, I wouldn't. Okay, so I wouldn't have accepted it anyway because it didn't follow the rules.
Well, as you said, you weren't exactly the most clear on the video camera.
That was a little bit of a miscommunication on prior part, yeah, but he could have just cut this part out, and
he's got custom hands.
Oh, he does? I didn't notice that. Oh, yeah, you're right, he does. Huh.
Wait, this confused me at first. I guess they're throwing him up in the air?
Yeah, that's why I laughed so hard.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, that would be kind of... Okay,
that part at the end kind of looked bad.
Oh, wow, he won a cookie. Good for him. Except that looks...
Boy.
Okay, even though that cookie looked like a cake from his perspective. So, yeah, this... okay, so this probably would not have made it into the collab anyway because there was no actual fighting. It was just them insulting each other. And also, there was video camera in there, so I would have had to make him cut that part out. Aside from that, so it wouldn't have made it into the collab because it didn't really follow the rules. But just by itself, this is actually pretty funny.
Points of creativity, at least.
Oh, definitely, yeah. No question about that.
It gets originality points, but pretty much mm-hmm. nothing else.
Yeah, the originality points for sure, but... originality wasn't necessarily what I was going for. It's like the collab had pretty clear rules and like guidelines and whatnot that people were supposed to follow.
Where's 166 Eric's entry?
He didn't send me one, which is why I didn't include it. So, yeah.
He wouldn't have sent us one.
Yeah, I mean, if I'm being honest, though, like, it probably wouldn't have been good enough to, like, meet my standards anyway, so,
Whoa, hold on, Mac.
Yeah?
Do you remember who 166 Eric is?
Yeah, I do. Oh, wait, yeah, that him. Yeah.
All right, just make
moving sure. On. I hear someone screaming in the background. I don't think that was on purpose. Oh, saw a hand.
This might be the most quality voice acting I've seen in this collab so far.
That is unfortunate. Nathan St. Pierre's entry. It's Vizon versus Zeri, so what was that?
Okay, just far too dark.
Mm-hmm.
Far too dark, far too shaky. I saw a hand.
I saw two hands.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
I just want to state this right now. Even if you're relatively new at making YouTube videos, Bionicle videos especially, or action scenes especially, if you're going to make sound effects with your mouth, just
don't.
You can download, just look, Google, or not even Google, YouTube search a sound effect that you want, like a punching sound effect or mm-hmm. like a laser sound effect. Uh-huh. And then just download the YouTube video with any of the thousands of online video downloaders.
Yeah, there's a couple of, like, people that I know who, like, otherwise have really good videos that are kind of holding back for me because they use their mouth instead of correct punching sounds. Not going to name any names here, Rigel 2. But yeah, that's definitely something those people could fix. What else have we got?
I think you named a name there.
What? No, I didn't. Stop making stuff up. Okay, so we got Scumbag Gaming. Where is yours? Yours got sent in super late, like literally the day before I uploaded the thing. So it is Abaddon the Despoiler versus the Emperor of Mankind. Three guesses as to which entertainment franchise these two characters were inspired by.
Oh yeah, I think I remember his entry for my call.
Mm-hmm.
That's actually some... Oh... Every once in a while, this animation looks pretty.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
stop
the
motion camera panning.
Oof.
I just wish there was more action.
Yeah, more of them actually fighting would be nice.
Thanos snap.
Oh man.
Kind of suffers from music video
mm-hmm.
problems.
A little bit. I have no idea what that's supposed to be. So
there were enough action and quite slow.
There were a couple sections of there that actually had fairly smooth looking animation.
Mm-hmm.
And I think he may have just been rushing this too much because there I would say more than half of the actual movements are like two frames in this.
Yeah, definitely. He spent more effort on the actual video effects than he did on the animation, which definitely knocked points off for me. Also, this one was sent in super late, and people had 4 months to make their entries. So, yeah, I didn't really look at too many late entries all that carefully because of that reason. Let's see. Oh, Rigel 2, here is yours, Aria versus Astrus. Off the bat, really like the animation. Pretty smooth.
Yes, credit where credit is due for the high frame rate animation. That is not easy to pull off.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. This is pretty nice looking. Audio's a bit low.
He put in a comment that this was 30 FPS, if I remember?
Not consistently 30 FPS, but pretty close. It's yeah, definitely nice.
Still frames, but yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yippee! Yep. I wonder who this was inspired by. I can't quite put my finger on it.
Doodaloo.
It's like a shame.
Oh, listen to this.
Five, but choppier. Oh, I guess he was referring just to the previous battle.
He literally made a whistling noise with his mouth, I'm pretty sure, so yeah, points off for that.
Although, I think he had the effect go behind the mock there, didn't he?
Yeah.
I mean, I don't think there's anything technically wrong with using mouth effects. It's just, you gotta edit it to make it less obvious.
Most people can tell when it's a mouth effect, even if it's edited, so...
Okay, I just want to say right there that the neck flopping looked very weird.
Yeah, that was... I liked what he was going for, but it was a little bit janky, yeah.
He kind of over-animated that part. If you're going to have, like, an impact like that, it needs to be... It needs to have a quick downward... Like, when he slaps his head down, it needs to be quick, but then you can have the bounce after that, but not that exact.
Good days in music, at least. I recognize the song.
Oh, what's it from?
I don't know if this is the same rendition, but it's from the Kirby series.
Oh, well, I wouldn't know that because I've never played a Kirby game. What the hell is that? Seizure warning, Jesus!
Yeah, it's like what it's a boss theme for this giant like wasp queen thing. I admit you put up a good fight, but it was still
stupid to challenge me. Booyah! If it wasn't for the fucker that I didn't want to kill
you, you would already... Shade, are you alright over there?
I'm under the weather. So I still got the coughings.
Man, you're not even under the weather. You're practically 6 feet underground. Oof. That is unfortunate.
The coughing seems to come and go. I just want to be better.
Yeah,
I know I've already promised one guy I'd do voice acting for him, but I can't do my voices better because I want to give him the best I can.
Yeah, I feel your pain. My voice is not the best right now either, probably because of all the screaming I did last night. Okay, so Rigel, things I liked. The choreography you had was really nice. Lots of like realistic attacks and whatnot. The way you handled the camera was pretty nice too. Gotta fix the audio though. Like, not enough punching effects, and also like the voices were like really really quiet. I feel it sounds like you were like. It sounded like you were recording while your parents were asleep and you didn't want to wake them. Okay. Oh, here's another real good one from Leopleurodon. This one did also make it into the collab. Leopleurodon, if you're watching this. This is for you.
Yeah, with bootleg Jenny from My Life as a Teenage Robot.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I wonder if this dude's a fan of that show.
Yeah, I wonder too.
Hmm. It's possible. Huzzah!
Yeah, Marasmus.
I absolutely love how Vizon is characterized in this entry. It's great.
Yeah, oof. Exactly. Same here.
And he finds a top hat!
I wonder how he got the top hat to stick on. What was it, like putty paste?
Probably.
What is this, Dragon Ball Z?
Probably.
Hey, hang on a second. These effects are actually pretty damn awesome.
They are pretty good, yeah. This is one of the things I definitely liked about it. Were the effects.
Force push.
Okay, this is definitely fake spells. You can tell by how strange the language is.
Oh yeah, because you totally know what the difference between real magic and fake magic.
Oh yeah, true.
Giant bees!
Ooh.
Ooh.
That's a neat idea.
I'm getting base... .exe buys from this, from Battle Network.
Back here!
I kind of want to know why he has a green screen up if he's not going to use it.
Yeah, that is kind of one thing that's a little bit weird about this. It's like, sometimes it's green screen, and sometimes it's just them... Did he actually use the... He only actually used the green screen for the effects a couple of times, and the rest is just them flying around the basement.
Vizon wins. The original character loses. That's so strange.
Uh-huh, that was an interesting choice.
I know Creamy Bio2 Stalker will be happy about that.
What a twist!
Yeah,
and apparently he's a Smash Brothers.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I actually kind of enjoyed that at the end with the victory. Mm-hmm. On to the next battle.
Yeah, I mean... Yeah, I don't have too many negative things to say about this one. This was just fun to watch.
I have one little nitpick, and it has to do with the effects.
Mm-hmm. Now,
the effects were absolutely fantastic for most of the video. There's one part though when the machine. I don't know. Did they give the Jenny robot a name, or was it just machine the whole time?
I couldn't tell you.
Well, there's this part where she jumps up. I'm assuming it's a she. Jumps
probably
up into the sky and then like shoots lasers down at Vizon. And you can see like there's a glow around the lasers, but it just cuts off in the middle of the screen.
Oh, yeah, I know what part you're talking about. Yeah, that part could have been done a little bit better. Yeah. But yeah, other than that, this was a pretty good entry.
Yeah.
I agree.
Mm-hmm. Let's see, here's another one that did not make it in.
The one and only Spud Bud?
Mm-hmm. Luke Plot in 2000. Her name is Lyra, it says at the beginning of the video. Oh, well, I wasn't paying attention, so whatever.
You're in charge of these things. You need to be paying attention to these.
Well, you're part of the stream, too. You should pay attention. I can't do everything.
Yeah, but you were the one in charge of the whole collab.
This one's kind of violent.
Yeah, a little bit. This one actually isn't bad. Like...
It's janky, though.
It's definitely janky. Also, the complete lack of music's a little off-putting, if you ask me. The sound effects are good, though. The punching actually feels good. And also the stabbing and slicing.
Yeah, credit for actually using sound effects.
Mm-hmm. I mean, if you have to choose between music and sound effects, I would go for sound effects, although it's better to have both.
That seemed like two different fight scenes, to be honest, combined into one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it seemed like he started the fight scene with the two characters, and then he was just like, this ended up being too short. Let's add two more characters.
Yeah.
It's not like my entry where there was kind of story purposes for having different battles. This one just feels like disconnected.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like the camera turn, and then there's suddenly two people just standing behind them watching the whole time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Overall, the action was actually pretty decent. It's just, could have been a bit more quicker, a bit cleaner, that sort of thing. Let's see.
Yeah,
oh, Shade, I think
you probably should have planned it in advance.
Oh, mm-hmm. Yeah, this is Mika's.
Yep, I was like, I'm pretty sure you're familiar with this, guys. This is another one that made it...
Yeah, he was my... One of my closest friends.
Mm-hmm.
Although I think Max, I think you're tied as my close right now.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we're tied. Oh, okay. Interesting. Interesting.
Nope, I don't know. But
there can be only one.
I watched this one before the collab came out, and I actually laughed at it pretty hard.
Mm-hmm. Pretty... Oh, good. Grex, I wanted to review. Oh, you have to. You're leaving? Leaving, Grex? No.
Adios, amigo.
He's like, my video's done. I gotta get out of here.
Mm-hmm. It's like, yeah, I got my shout out from three of my favorite BioTubers, so that's all I really wanted out of the stream. Okay, bye-bye.
Taco boy.
Yeah, this is a reference to like a video his friend made for my collab.
No, don't tell me. I don't even know.
That was cool.
I love how this video, like, absolutely devolves into chaos at the end.
Uh-huh. That was actually one of my bigger complaints about the video, if I'm being honest, but overall this one was pretty funny.
Oh, shit.
Ooh, is that another one of those custom masks? Because that looks pretty good.
Yo, is that Dave?
Yeah, Mika does a lot of custom stuff. He uses duct tape a lot in sanding.
Oh, he's saying bye to Leopleurodon. Oh, my bad. I thought he was saying bye to us instead of Leopleurodon. Okay, bye-bye, Leopleurodon. See you later. Grax Wanderer, welcome back, even though you didn't technically leave. That was my mistake. I didn't read the comments closely enough.
Is that, like, an edited clip from the original... From the movie?
I think it is, yeah. And then... I was like, wait... That was hilarious. I was like, wait, what?
I think that was red versus blue music in the background as well.
Uh-huh.
Like when the mm-hmm. warthog comes in.
Mine!
Hello.
And then we just have Vegeta show up.
Get a little Kenobi.
Not a whole lot happening.
We need a video of Mika versus Sherry's in a battle of friendship for Shade. Yes, we do.
We needed that a long time ago. Take me by the hand, lead me by the hand.
I like the idea of a Toa of Water that summons that song when he starts using
his tongue. Oh, yeah. So, what I liked about this was funny as hell. Especially the part where, like, the Mecha Woody showed up. I was like, I have no idea what's going on right now, but I absolutely love it. That was hilarious.
Yes, I don't even know what to say. It's perfect.
Mm-hmm. One thing that I would change is that it was a little too random, if that makes sense. So it's like, towards the end of the video, after Mecha Woody showed up, it kind of went a little bit downhill, because the impression I got was that he was more focused on making things as random, as weird as possible, that he forgot to actually include, like, enough action to justify having all those characters in one place. It was really, really cluttered towards the end. That one panning shot you saw where there's, like, nothing happening for, like, 5 whole seconds... He was like, I ran out of ideas. But
now that I think about it.
Mm-hmm. Now that you think about what I didn't you cut out there.
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't know how that happened. Can you hear me?
I can hear you now, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, my internet dropped out for a second.
Oh, jeez.
So, yeah, towards the end, instead of actual fighting, it was just random character shows up, then cut to another random character showing up, then mm-hmm. cut to another random character showing up. It wasn't really fighting at the end, but still,
exactly.
It was funny enough for me to over.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, animation could have been a bit smoother, too, if you ask me, but overall, this is a pretty good entry. Pretty funny.
Yeah.
The Mecha Woody was absolutely brilliant. I love that part of it. Okay, here's another one that did not make it in. I believe this was a late entry. Tree Cutter versus Rockshelite by Cave Spider 3. I don't know what happened to the other two.
You traitor!
You traitor.
So we have bootleg Gresh here.
I guess. Why is his
Middle
hand backwards?
Gresh.
Why is his hand backwards?
Okay, so it's... So I can tell this was shot at different times of the day.
Oh yeah, definitely. Oh my god! Look at his shoulders!
That's what the hard thing about stop motion.
Man, what an absolute unit.
You're just gonna leave him there?
Alright.
Oh, and it ends. Just ends. Yeah, not too much to say about this one. Really, really short. Probably why it didn't make it in.
Action wasn't too bad, but yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true. The action was actually
kinda lacked a little bit of,
mm-hmm.
I don't know, it lacked something.
This one definitely felt really rushed, yeah. Let's see.
If I could say anything, just, like, make sure you're... If it's sunny, try to film earlier in the day, if possible. And if it starts getting dark, then stop filming and wait until the next day. It's trust me, it's better when you try to have consistent lighting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
or block out all sunlight and use, like, artificial lights without moving.
Right, if you don't have any like light, filming lights, like I don't.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, me either. I really need to get my hands on some of those.
I mean, my birthday / Christmas present last year was basically a new camera, so.
Hmm. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, so this is one that almost made it in, but I switched it up for like someone else's. Not as productions. I'm back. Welcome back, Bionicosaurus. Honestly, just cutting out all sunlight is the best. I agree. Nye does things. Okay.
Keith Myers. Hey, guys. Hello there.
Oh, hello, Keith. Keith Myers.
We'll get into yours eventually, X250.
X25 Productions, please review mine. Wait, what just happened? I missed it.
He caught a sniper bullet and then turned around and threw it right back into the barrel of the sniper rifle and made it
Damn.
Ooh.
Okay, this is actually pretty good so far.
Yeah, like I said, this is one of those ones that, like, I switched out at the last minute for, like, someone else's, I think. Like...
Yo, he just swapped his arm out. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, this was a good one.
Okay, this one just went to black all of a sudden.
Uh-huh. Yeah, and then it just stops. I guess he's in his lair right now, making a new weapon or something. I don't really know.
He's making a new arm or something. Yeah, that pacing is a little off. So uh-huh. He just leaves, fixes himself, and comes.
Yeah, the fight literally stops halfway through so he can go and get gear, and... He just stays there waiting for him, I guess.
I think I kicked his bum long enough. Maybe I'll just wait and see what happens.
His name is Goji, so probably.
Oh, nice.
Ah, jeez. What was that intro? yeah, this is another one of those ones that came really close, and honestly, I feel like it might have been better if I'd included it, but I don't really know which other intro I would have swapped it out for.
I think you could. He could literally just cut out the scene of him like welding a new arm on. And
yeah,
it would have been perfect.
Yeah, that was my other like only other real major criticism of it too is like it literally just stopped halfway through and then picked back up again. And the Goji or the Godzilla looking dude literally just stayed there waiting for him, which was kind of weird, but. Okay.
That was supposed to be an entry? I don't know if you ever told me or not.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh boy, here we go.
Oh boy. Oh boy, here we go. Got this one at like the last minute, but oh man, I am glad I included it.
I'm surprised how well he's able to do it in such a short amount of time.
Yeah, he did this in like just a couple days, which is amazing considering how smooth the animation is. Oh god, the crunchiness.
This is by far the most intense video Toe of Ultimate Doom has on his channel.
One of the most, yeah.
I think this is the...
He just doesn't even care. He's like, oh, my arm's bent the wrong way. Well, he just snaps it back into place and it's fine.
Like, I just like how this video takes advantage of like them actually being toys where you stick stuff into them.
Right.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's definitely true.
Enough of this. What is with the fighting? There is no
refreshing. You know, he's a Matora, not a Taraga. Why does he sound like a Taraga?
What is the point?
This is like his favorite voice.
Oh.
And then he's like, I don't know how to end this video. Merk him.
So I've shown a ton of Toe of Ultimate Doom's videos to my roommate, and by far no video from BioTube has ever made him laugh as much as Toa of Ultimate Doom's videos.
Oh, yeah, like, in terms of, like, action comedy, this is probably, like, the best of them all. This one was just hilarious. And, oh my god, those crunching sound effects made me cringe, but in a good way. Yeah, I don't really have anything bad to say about this one. This was just good. I'm amazed he made that so quickly, because, like, it was really last minute. Okay, here's another one that didn't make it in. Alpha versus The Last Guardian by Nui Janek. Oh, there is sound in there after all.
Power director, so another app editor.
Yeah, another app editor, so that probably one of the things that made it lose points for me. Vulture Reviews.
Oh, Lord, hello. He coming.
Oh, Lord, he coming.
Okay, so it feels kind of stiff.
Guardians of Ouroboros. Yeah. The newest vid on this channel was going to be an entry, but I decided last minute not to enter it. Why did you choose not to enter it? That's weird. I mean,
at the very least, it could have gone on this, even if it didn't make it.
Uh-huh. But
then again, I guess he wouldn't have known if that we were doing that.
Oh,
yeah, that was actually pretty good.
That was cool. I guess he's teleporting or something.
He put on the Mask of Shadows, and now he's full edge.
He's full edge. Also, I guess he's police or something, because it says police on his armor, if you notice that.
Yeah.
Vulturex Reviews, please don't make hellish noises again. My throat actually hurts from last night, so I probably will not. Yeah, you know what? Let Wombat Combat do it. I think he's the only one of us who isn't sick.
I'm sick of everything.
Interesting.
I'm sick of the world. The world's crap.
Oof.
I'm sick of this live stream. Bye.
Oh. Okay, bye-bye.
Oof, that really hurts.
Oof. That is an oof and a half right there. Those like just two kidding. Whole oofs. Oh, shoot, he's back! Alright then. I don't know, this one just felt like it was kind of it was really, really rushed. That's all I can really say about it.
Mine was good. Choreography, okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, actually, the mocks were pretty nice, I will say that.
The nicest thing I could say about it was that one effect that with the blade where it looked like it was kind of transforming or something like that. That was actually kind of neat.
That was neat, yeah. That was a neat little effect he had. Okay, so this is Bionicle Battles, Kongu versus Thok by X250. Hey, X250, this is yours. So, let's take a look at it. Where have I heard this song before?
I don't know if I have.
It's from my old Fight for Enrolled videos. I use this song all the time.
Oh. I need to find Thok. Yeah, you said you need to find Thok, but you're not moving.
Yeah, he's literally just standing still. And
okay.
Yeah. Oh, there he is.
I found Thok.
Oh, you found Thok. He was standing in front of you the whole time. Yeah. Kongu, you're terrible at finding things. Where did he... Oh man, Thok's blind too! He literally... Did he jump or did he just vanish? I have no idea.
Is there even any actual animation here?
Obviously it's still images.
Yeah, me too.
Slideshow.
You're right, this is a slideshow. This isn't,
It's like Scott... It's like early BioTube. Just with even less animation.
Uh-huh.
Bash on that!
Oh, video camera. Yeah, no, would have disqualified it. Or it would have made him cut it out. Grax Wanderer, BioTube 2008 flashbacks. Yeah, this looks and feels and sounds like a video from, like, 2008. But it is 2019. It's like, yeah, no. Thok, die now.
I hope no one finds that we're being too mean about this stuff.
Uh-huh. Like, I'm not going out of my way to, like, be mean, but, like... Oh, yeah, video camera again would have made him cut that out. Extra 50 versions, I need practice. Yeah, this felt like it was, like, really, really rushed, and you didn't, like, put as much effort into this as you could have. Because, like, yeah. Definitely work on your, like, stop motion stills. Like, this felt like a slideshow of still images instead of actual stop motion animation. But, yeah. Okay, let's...
Do not bring up Movie Maker. It is a plague upon man. I've been of an editor for years. It brings me war flashbacks.
Don't talk to me about war flashbacks. Actually, video productions, I will keep trying. Yes, that is how you improve. You keep trying and eventually you get better. Okay, this is Chris Lanicus's
entry. How many inches do we got?
Left? Yeah, I'm guessing you guys are starting to get a little bit tired. Yeah, 1, 2, 3.
This all day.
Nice. We have 12 left.
And how many do we have total?
49.
Okay, so we got about a quarter left.
Yeah. So we could wrap this up in like half an hour easy if we like kind of skim through these. I saved like the best few for last though, so that should like at least let us go out in a high note. Okay, so this is Zontonix versus Tialalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalalal rocks. The proportions are a little weird, but...
This is the ones that made it in, right?
Yes, this did make it in.
Yeah.
Extra 50, peace out, y'all. Okay, yeah, just stuck around until I actually talked about yours. Alright, see you later. I have no idea what the... So I guess
I'm
they're using...
Balrog 3-2-1 flashbacks right now.
Yeah, I guess these are supposed to be, like, summons or something? Because, like, just, like...
Stando!
Yeah. Yeah, I figured you'd say that. I was like, is he going to pet it or is he going to step on it? So yeah, animation.
I like... Yeah, he steps on it and it just sits down and dies.
Yeah, these mocks definitely have some balance issues. I can see that, and it's pretty clear. But, I like the part where they summon the creatures to, like, fight for him. That was pretty cool. It's like Pokemon, almost.
Although it does kind of just ignore what they're doing while the two are fighting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a little bit.
Credit for, actually animating the pain effects.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, it's pain effects, so it could have been better, but, so, yeah.
They are actual stop motion instead of two frames of pain effects being played back.
Mm-hmm. Borok 3-2-1, what? You heard him. Pokemon got abusable. yeah.
Yeah, that's how Peter would describe it.
A little bit. Yeah.
Does anyone even take Peter seriously anymore?
Not after the whole Steve Irwin incident, definitely not.
Why they gotta be so mean to Steve?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this one did make it in. This is Bionicle Dimensions by Toa Kalek.
I still don't really understand why it's called Bionicle Dimensions other than this portal effect here.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure this all takes place in one single dimension, so... Whatever.
Is this like a spin-off of Lego Dimensions?
Possibly.
Pew! 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 Now I'm just reminded of that one video made for the Custom Bionicle Wiki.
Mm-hmm.
If anybody remembers those.
I definitely don't.
How does a laser gun run out of ammo?
That is a good question.
Maybe it runs out of energy?
That's always a question I had about Star Wars movies, but I don't think we ever got an answer for. I'm digging this choreography, and the 360 camera thing was pretty neat, too.
That? No.
what was that? It was like... There's like...
It was two swords tickling each other.
Imagine
that's weird.
Imagine the
You're
scene
weird.
From Princess Bride with the two sword with a sword fight, and then instead they just like stand still and jiggle their swords against each other.
Oh, that's hilarious! I guess he just shoved his sword up his buttle or something right there. That was kind of weird. I don't know where it went.
Pocket dimension. That's why it's called Bionicle Dimensions.
You know what? You're probably right.
Maybe the butthole is a portal to another
butthole dimension.
Uh-huh. It's a pathway to happiness.
This way. So... the biddle head being on backwards confused me. Especially when he punched it and it looked like the head was gonna flip her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that head was weird looking. Ooh! Ow.
Yeah, that was good.
And he just got back up like it was nothing.
Anyone think the walking and leaping was kind of more like dancing? Especially
that was my biggest criticism about this one. I think I told him about it. Yeah, the walking animations were really janky because, I mean...
At least he did the legs, though.
Yeah, but he was filming on like a hardwood floor, so there wasn't like a lot of friction. But the choreography was pretty good. I liked it. Captain Sterix noticed me, Senpai Mac. Okay.
Notice me, senpai!
Sorry, what was that?
Lord Mac and Cheese, notice me.
Okay, you know, whoever did that last voice just sounded like Trilo doing that, saying that.
I have no idea who that is, but okay.
So I really like. Are we gonna critique that one?
Oh, I thought we did already. Oh, was there anything you wanted to say about it?
I was just gonna say the camera effects on that one were pretty good.
Yeah, the 360 the actual, spin was good.
The frame rate was decent enough to follow it, and it looked well. The actual fighting choreography was good enough to follow.
Mm-hmm. Dante95, who was the guy that won the Bionicle Battles collab? There was no winning. It wasn't a contest. It was a collab. There was no winning or losing. There was just people that I decided to include and everyone else. No, Thatch did not submit anything, which was quite unfortunate because I would have liked to see something from him, but he was probably busy doing something. Okay, so...
The greatest Bionicle stop motion fights of all time.
All right. Prepare yourselves, boyos! Here we go!
Prepare your buttholes.
Prepare your pocket dimensions.
Prepare your anus!
Fatality.
That reminded me of that one joke video Bi-Rock Dude did. Gore versus MK Charles?
Mm-hmm.
Hang on, let's watch that again.
Oh yes, let's experience this greatness one more time.
So, yeah,
that's actually
and it's good. Over.
So, uh-huh. How many frames was that? Like, maybe...
I think it's 20? Like 15, 16, if that. No, I think it was a little bit more than that. This was, fun fact, this was actually the very first entry I was submitted for the collab all the way back in January.
That makes sense.
Yes, it is. It does make sense because of how short it is. Here's...
Well, I don't see anything wrong with it.
I mean... So you should... It's the greatest stop-motion Bionicle fight of all time. Like, honestly, I'm completely stupid for not including it, clearly.
Right, though, you should do a stream probably... critique in different BioTube series. That would take way too long.
Oh, God, yeah, no. Like, a video, maybe, but a stream? No, my vocal cords would be fried after, like, the first 2 hours. They're already fried as it is. Okay, so, Bionicle collab. Enter. Okay, then. Josh Brosh. Yeah, a little entree. A collab on Trudelu.
This is looking like another slideshow.
It's a slightly faster slideshow than the last one. It wasn't a tournament, it was a collab. Those are two very different things. In collabs, everyone comes together to do one thing. In tournaments, a bunch of people come together to do a thing and only one person leaves. Big difference.
There can only be one.
Rigel 2, at least critique Bionicle Legacy. Maybe.
The Rakshi fell asleep because he was saying, for so long.
Okay, so if one of the characters is so bored that they fall asleep in the video, that's not really a good indicator of how exciting it's going to be. Just saying.
I want to say one thing for a collab entry. Let's see how much that soldier training probably get, huh? Don't begin your collab entry with an explanation as to why someone's doing a collab. Because it kind of just slows down the whole thing.
The exception to that was Legend Weavers when he said that I was doing a collab. That was actually pretty funny.
Yeah, I mean, if it's for a joke, that's good. But if you're just trying to build context, then we already know what it's for.
It's like, it's Bionicle characters killing each other. You don't need context.
Exactly.
You don't need context. That's something I wish I'd learned earlier. What the hell is that? What am I looking at? Did they just
combine?
What? Oh my god, they fused! They combined. This suddenly became way more interesting.
Why did
he just? Did he literally just fart? No. I think he did.
Just who in the hell do you think I am?
I am Farticus.
Did you just end that saying this was the best fight ever?
No.
Best guy ever?
Best guy ever.
Oh, okay.
Okay then. I definitely liked the whole part where they fuse together. That was unique. I wish it just would have been like executed a little bit better, and that wouldn't have been a glorified slideshow. But okay, so
where's the fusion dance? I didn't see it.
Yeah, no fusion dance. Kind of have to take points off of that. Ivax the Awesome. This is one I received a long time ago. Are mocks or cannon sets better? I don't know. Let's ask Creepy Biotube Stalker. What do you think?
Is it just me, or does it seem like the audio was just recorded and not actually downloaded?
I think that's what happened here, yeah.
Yo, Leywood just killed Ivax the Awesome.
Oof.
Clearly not so
awesome. Hands. Hands.
So many hands in just a short time span.
Uh-huh.
Wait, did it just start, like, show the beginning of the video again?
I think it looped.
It looked like it was setting up to loop or something, yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah, no. So, yeah, like, you showed your hand. Oh, hey, Ivax the Awesome. Yeah, that was yours. Yep, showed your hands way too much right there towards the end. Should have cut that out.
Animation wasn't actually that bad.
The animation was decent. Yeah, it was not all that bad. Also, the part where they're just standing still while the, whatever that vehicle was called, was just, like, shooting them was kind of funny.
Axelera, I think?
Axelera,
yeah, it's been so long, I barely remember.
I had very few of the vehicle sets. And that was, and the ones I did have was after Bionicle's cancellation.
Mm-hmm. Obviously, that's my uploaded list. Exterminator versus Crimson by LegoDude13. I think this is one of the ones that came close to be including, but I didn't at like the last minute for whatever reason.
Oh. Sound effects are pretty good.
The sound effects are very nice. I think they're ripped straight out of Transformers.
Oh, okay.
Still work, though? Hey, whatever works. Oh, you saw a hand? I missed that.
Yeah.
Okay, so too short, obviously. It cut off really abruptly. I wanted it to be longer. But other than that, I liked the animation. Pretty good.
It was weird.
Hold on. The name Crimson. Maybe it cut off early because it was King Crimson in the fight.
Oh, God.
I mean, the fight animation seemed a little stiff in my eyes, but the other animation bits were actually really nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so that one wasn't too bad, but there were other entries I received that were better, so that's probably why I didn't make it in. Bionicle Battle Collab by Gasket.
Chunky Boy.
Is this Metal Gear music? No, this is Metal Gear Revengeance music, I think.
For some reason, I'm thinking Xenoblade, although I don't know.
I couldn't tell you. I've never played Xenoblade. Anthony is queer to our Bionicles so popular because Bionicles are the best toy ever, and you can't disagree with me because I'm objectively correct. Okay, this was made on an app. I don't really have too much to say about that one. What do you think?
Needed sound effects.
Mm. Yeah, you're probably right.
The fight scene was pretty cool.
Yeah.
They actually fought
a little bit. Yeah. Oh, here's Clognogs. This was a really good one. You'll notice this one's actually longer than the version that you saw in the collab because I told him it was too long, so he had to cut out a few parts of it. But
I'll fully admit I didn't really care for this one, I'll be honest. It just seemed kind of slow. It didn't seem like things went anywhere that fast.
Mm.
And it,
yeah.
This one also gives me Bo-Rock 321 vibes, only instead of being Bionicle System Sets, it's Mars Mission.
Yeah, definitely. I actually almost didn't include this one because it was just Bionicles and Legos, and it took a while for me to get to the actual fighting. But just because of like how much effort he actually put into this one, I ended up including it because like, production value wise and like all that stuff, it was actually pretty good if you ask me.
Oh god.
Oh, this is, I'm definitely getting Borok 321 vibes from this one. Oh, oh man.
He just grabs the head.
It's like, I'll take this.
I should have paid for my kill.
Is that an alarm? Because that's birds.
I have absolutely no idea. Steed.
So I was a little confused about the allegiance of the aliens in the Mars from the Mars mission theme. Are they working together with the Mars mission, or are they all fighting against the aliens?
I have no idea.
Yeah, ooh! Yeah, I was a little confused about this stuff here.
Man, this one's violent as hell! Get their heads blown off, arms blown off.
This is cartoony violent.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but in my opinion, that's good. The music doesn't really match the setting all that well, I'll say that, but whatever. Probably literally just googled royalty-free music and then clicked one of the first results he saw.
So who were you guys rooting for? The Mars mission or the Bionicle?
The Bionicles, obviously.
Me too, obviously.
Obviously. That's the only correct answer. Bionicles are better than humans.
Pohatu did.
He did.
I love how he added these little claymation part in the middle of it too.
Mm-hmm.
Claymation zombies.
Claymation zombies, the best kind of zombie.
I don't know if you guys are familiar with it, but a long time ago there was
Mecha X. What's up, everyone? We went over your entry earlier. If you want to go back in the stream and check it out, feel free. Gonna wrap things up here pretty soon, I think. Yeah, we need to wrap things up before Shade keels over and dies.
Oof.
That big oof. Oh! Damn! So I guess a virus is, like, possessing both of them or something? I think, I'm not 100% sure.
Maybe the zombies are, or the zombie bionicles are on the side of the alien.
Maybe, yeah, I don't know.
The lack of clarity is one of the reasons why I didn't really care for this one, to be honest.
I mean, yeah, that's a fair criticism.
Why are Borok working together with Toa?
I think it's just bionicles in general working together. I don't think the allegiance matters all that much.
Met wants to know if he can add you on Discord, Mac.
I mentioned this to him earlier, later, once I've set up a channel Discord, which I will get to in 50,000 years. I've been meaning to get one set up for a long time, and I just haven't gotten around to it because I'm lazy.
I have no idea how to set up a Discord server.
Yeah, me neither. That's another reason why I haven't done it. I don't know how, because I'm stupid. Like, it took us almost an hour just to, like, get this entire stream set up. You seriously think I'm smart enough to set up a Discord server and run the thing successfully by myself?
you technically did set up a Discord server for the three of us.
Yeah, well, only because you told me how to.
Hey, I had to look it up myself, to be honest, so...
Yeah, it's still...
Kind of bare bones, too. There's nothing special about it.
All the effects come from, like, the claymation and stuff, yeah.
I mean, he has Discord, Voltrix.
This music is actually, like, kind of catchy, though.
Uh-huh. I'm getting, like, lo-fi hip-hop beats to chill and study to. What?
I think that... That plastic thing the Bionicles are on are an Imaginext playset. You guys know what that is?
Maybe?
Oh yeah.
Huh.
I used to have a ton of those.
Interesting. I didn't have Imaginext because they weren't Legos and therefore they were irrelevant to me.
I had a phase of Imaginext.
I had a Bakugan phase a long ass time ago, but not anymore.
I mean, I've gotten some of the new ones. I just wish I kept on to the old one.
Beyblade, Beyblade, let it rip.
Yeah, that's definitely a match next.
No, not Kopaka. Wait, is he infected or is he just bleeding out of his nose a lot? Oh, jeez.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. And then everyone just dies at the end. Brilliant.
Everyone died. Yeah.
Victory sound effect.
Dun 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 dun.
Now we have to fight the zombies.
Uh-huh. Yeah, like I said, I told him to cut out a few parts. It's over. And
that's the best end screen ever.
True. 10 out of 10 best end screen of all time. That was pretty good.
All right.
Too long, though. Yeah, I actually made him cut out
some
parts.
That's a long-winded video.
Yep. Like I said, Cam made him cut out some parts. Let's see.
But overall, like, amount of work put into it and the actual animation, pretty damn good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, here is one by RM Studios. This is another one that didn't make it in.
They're doing it again.
Again? Oh, yeah, you mentioned that earlier. That's kind of a point off.
They're introducing themselves.
Where is the warning? Don't give me that look. You know exactly where he is. Alright, fine. If you don't tell me...
Not a bad looking gun.
Yeah, but is he literally just having a conversation with himself? Because that's what it feels like is happening right now.
That would actually probably make things more hilarious.
Uh-huh. Yeah, all of these characters sound exactly the same. I don't know who, like, the only reason I know is talking right now because they're the only ones on screen.
Oh, trust me, when I did my old series before BioTube, a lot of my guys sounded the same too.
A little bit.
It helps if you add a 2-frame head bob animation to whoever's talking.
Yep, just make them straight up headbang. That works.
Makes some kind of motion when they're talking.
I mean, that's why I have characters move their heads and arms around. I don't care, my daughter. Dead because of you. Yes. Anyway,
I'm not the worst
one. Very static.
Yeah. Yep.
And in the most painful way possible.
Holy crap, Grax actually voiced all his characters in his entry?
God damn, Grax, you got some range.
That's pretty impressive.
Wow. Rex Wonder had Mac voiced everyone as well. What, are you talking about like in my old videos? Oh god, it suddenly got so loud.
Thanos. He turned into Thanos for a second.
I think he did, yeah.
Shoot him in the balls.
Okay, I get what he was going for here, to have, like a ton of punching and stuff right there, but it was a bit too slow.
When he actually does the animation, it looks decent.
It does, yeah, you're right.
Are a problem.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the pacing. Definitely the pacing.
Pacing and voice acting are the two biggest problems with this one. Yeah. Purple Boy, basically everyone in Endworld sounds the same. I use voice filters and whatnot for a ton of them to try and make them sound unique, but I can't really argue that point. Yeah, that is a fair criticism to make. But Fight for Endworld compared to like my later stuff was not really all that good. Okay, we only got 3 left. We're on the final stretch, boys.
Oh boy.
How do
you feel to know BioTube is dead?
BioTube is on life support. I'm keeping it there until it stops being entertaining to me.
BioTube can't die. I have so much story I need to tell.
Uh-huh. Okay, so this is Josh Aaron's entry.
I don't know if that was supposed to be comedic or not.
If it... I mean, either way, that was funny as hell.
That mock looks familiar.
Yeah, I wonder who that was inspired by. I feel like I've seen him somewhere before. Oh, now they're outside.
To be fair, I've made quite a few mocks inspired by others. I mean, Clithon is literally just... Kylo Nuva's Helltraws just not as good.
Wait, is this video camera that's just like looped, or what's going on here?
I think he's adding multiple frames for still frames, which actually it's not a bad idea. Instead of having just a solid unmoving frame, having a little bit of camera shape or something.
I guess that might have been what he was going for, but
he's very clearly not using a tripod, though.
Oh, yeah. And then, like, the actual punches and stuff were really, really slow.
Oh, yeah.
This is basically just a slideshow. It's a slideshow with shaky cam.
I honestly can't tell if this is video or stop motion.
Yeah, me neither. It's like, it's weird. I don't know what he was going for here.
I think it's actually video. And for some reason, it's playing at a low frame.
That's possible, yeah. Oh, now they're just playing on their Switches.
Oh, it was a video game the whole time.
It was a video game Oh, and then he just murders him. Okay, beautiful.
This is the extreme case of gamers. The extreme end.
This is basically me every time someone kills me when I'm playing Dark Souls. They killed me in the game, so I killed them in real life. But, wow, okay, so video itself was, it was basically just a slideshow with shaky cam, so I would have liked to see more effort, like, actually put in the animation, but that intro was hilarious. Like, man. Yeah. Okay.
I want to watch that again.
The intro? Yeah. What the heck is that? Yeah, no complaints there. The beginning part of the video was great. It just kind of goes downhill from there. Oh well.
And he just kind of like flies in planking and lands on.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
This one was good.
This was a good one, yeah, from Fancy Pants Bionicle. So this is the second to last one.
Oh yeah, this was a really good one.
Uh huh. Yeah, like I said, I saved two of the best for last, so we could go out a high note.
Which the design?
So here we have Kallen, Lord of Fire, versus Nalak, Lord of Water.
Oh, that is. Isn't that Kallen? I don't know.
No, I'm just kidding.
Well, it sounds like it and looks like it is. I'm digging the beard. That was an interesting choice.
Oh. Strokes beard.
Hi, Met Productions. I have a question. What is it? What do you want to know? I'm going to go with your email.
Guardians of Ouroboros.
Yes.
I don't know. I don't know what the question was.
This is some good sword fighting. I like it. It's just Kallen beating up this old man.
Old man.
Men wants to email something.
Kallen, Lord of Fire, senior citizen abuse. caught on camera, no clickbait.
I mean, he's kind of fighting against a Gandalf, so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I literally have nothing bad to say.
Borak 321 has a good point. He's a wizard, but he's fighting with a sword.
That's true, yeah.
Gandalf also fought with a sword at times.
Yeah,
and he was teleporting around, so I guess that's magical.
A little bit. Yeah, I would have liked to see a little more magic from the actual wizard, but overall, that was a really, really good entry. Okay.
Set design.
Oh, good set design. Yes, you were right. All right.
Ten out of ten anime.
Voltrix, I know there's a channel called BioTube that's currently doing a collab, and I'm planning on announcing a new one myself early next month. I have a birthday video for my sister I'm working on. I'll probably do that first, and maybe also do that other collab video. But yeah, there's more collabs coming up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I feel like collabs are like the new hot thing that BioTube is doing now.
I just hope they don't become like overdone. Like too many people do them at once, it just doesn't become unique or special anymore.
I should host a collab.
Hey, do it. Why not? I mean, like, the thing with collabs is that the only people who can, like, actually, like, feasibly pull off collaborations are people who already have a lot of subscribers, because the thing with collabs is that you need a lot of people to, like, actually hear about it in order for it to work, so, like... Right.
Exactly.
Like...
I remember...
Sorry, what were you going to say?
I remember my first mock contest. I think it was for, like, 100 subs. I barely... I only got... I got very few entries. 6, maybe? I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see a lot of, like, new people do mock contests on, like, the off chance that, like, people will notice it. And, like, honestly, if you're just starting out, what would be better is if you just, like, focus on making your series or, like, mock reviews or whatever. And then, like, once you actually get people watching your stuff, then you can start doing stuff like...
Maybe, like, enter these collabs and these contests. At least then they can, if you do well enough, people will take notice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was the point of this collaboration, was to, like, show off people who I thought were pretty good at animation. Some people that, like, people already were familiar with, and then others that might not have a lot of subscribers.
The main thing I've discovered from BioTube, if you want to grow in popularity, is you need to focus on quality first and networking second.
Absolutely, yeah, because, like, it took me a while to get to, like, the 500 subs mark and then the 1,000 subs mark, but that was because I just put my head down and focused on actually making my videos good, and then people liked them, so I could start doing more networking stuff. I mean, I have 8,000 subscribers now, so it's like, if I do collabs, like, a lot of people pay attention to it.
Guardian of Ouroboros, I want to know if we could watch his entry, even though he didn't enter.
I'll watch it later if it's uploaded to your channel. Yeah.
All right
then.
I guess we're ready for the most intense entry.
Yes, arguably the best one, aside from Wombats, in my opinion.
No, by far better.
Wait. See, you're saying yours is better or this one is better?
Mason's is far better.
Yours, in my opinion, are very close. Like, I could literally, like, flip a coin, and, like, that would basically be the only way I could actually decide which one I liked more.
So my green screen looked better.
Definitely, yeah.
His backgrounds, oh my god.
Yeah, his backgrounds were amazing.
To do, like, a full 3D cityscape, but, like, that is...
Mm-hmm. Okay, Met Production, stop asking for my email. I only gave it out to people for the purpose of mailing me collaboration entries, so now that whole thing is over, I took it down. So if you want me to see stuff from you, upload it to your channel. Okay, Swanderer, thanks for the advices. I'll make a contest, though, because why not? Hey, people are starting to notice you, so if you think you can get away with it, why not? Although, I would rather you did focus on your series instead of doing, collabs or mock contests and stuff if you, like, don't have a whole lot of subscribers. But
I think right now he has about, like, 160 or so. That might not be enough for to get a decent amount of people for a collab. I mean, when I got 100 subs, I did a mock contest. Barely anyone entered.
Mm-hmm.
I did a mock contest when I was at, like, I think around 3,000 subs, and I maybe got, like, 40 entries.
You got 40 entries? That is a lot.
Well, like 40 emails, but
a
lot of them didn't really follow the rules at all, so.
Oh, okay.
Will you do another collab like this in the future? This is from Fire Fury. If you're talking about, we brought up the I've already brought up my collab idea, or someone else. You might be talking about, like, another Bionicle Battles collab.
If you're talking about me making another Battles collab, I mean, so recently after this one, I don't think so. Maybe, like, way later in the future, assuming I haven't taken BioTube off life support yet. We will see. I'd rather it be about a different subject than just Battles. I just did Battles because that's something I felt like people associated with my channel, so it'd be appropriate.
Yeah.
Okay. Met Productions, I'm so annoying. Grax, Met just posted this message. Yeah, Met, literally just stop spamming messages. It's like, you don't have to do that. People, like, probably find you less annoying if you just, like, commented and stopped spamming messages in the hopes I would see it. Trust me, I see what you're spamming. I'm just choosing not to respond to it because you're spamming it, if that makes sense. I'm sorry, I have no life. Everyone has things they can work on to improve in their life. So don't worry too much about it.
Hey, we all don't have lives, Matt. Don't worry.
I have nothing better to you.
You don't even want to know.
Oof.
Well, then again, at least I have a job, so...
Mm-hmm.
It's not really much.
Okay.
Let's watch a video.
You know what? Yes. Sorry, Wombat. You are absolutely correct. We have been staring at this screen with nothing going on for, like, the past 10 minutes while we've answered questions, and Shade's dying over there, so we should probably get this wrapped up before Shade keels over and, like, dies. So, without further ado...
Combat. Oh, no.
Jax, nice of you to join us.
You just now noticed the dude he was, like, stomping on. Really?
He is a tiny dude.
No! Tabdos!
Oh, no! Tabdos. What a tragedy.
Rakshi head.
At least he's a shorter dude.
I'll make you regret ever.
Rather than like tall and lanky or come increase boobage.
So right off the bat, excellent like fight choreography and god
oh
damn.
My god, yes.
God damn, this frame rate is dummy thick.
At the clapping of Jax's butt cheeks keeps alluding cars on.
Oh man, this frame rate's thicker than an ice cream sandwich. Those of you who watched my stream last night will understand that. Oh my god!
Oh, yes.
Matrix!
So, I noticed there's a bit of audio desync in this video.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like the motion doesn't really line up with the voice lines and some of the sound effects, but the animation is so good. It's...
Mm-hmm.
It's hard to
Met Productions, my stop motion is terrible compared to Mason's. Literally everyone's stop motion is terrible compared to Mason's. This is freaking incredible.
Eat out that ice cream sandwich.
Oh man, Shade, you should have been there. Who was it? It was either... If one of my subscribers said that his mocks would eat you out like an ice cream sandwich. I was like... So what, you mean you spread the two parts of the ice cream sandwich apart and go into the cream?
Sandwiches.
I was like, is that how you eat ice cream sandwiches? So yeah, that was a meme.
Don't we think ice cream sandwiches? Somebody needs to do art of that.
Dude, last night's stream is it only
round of applause. I wouldn't clap, but I have push the clock on.
I wasn't using my hands there, by the way.
Was that your thighs?
Yes.
Mania Mac is a dummy thick.
It's all the squats I do. Oh my god.
Well, you're a buff boy, aren't you?
I mean, actually, I lost weight. I dropped like 30 pounds in the past 3 months.
What, are you in the military or something?
Yes. I stopped doing weightlifting and I switched over to basically just doing cardio and calisthenics instead.
Oh, alright.
I mean, yeah, I'm trying to get like a nice six-pack going on, but in order for that to happen, I have to stop eating pastries and I don't want to do that, and that would make me sad.
Okay,
I'm just a skinny heck.
I have a bit of a critique for Mason Mox's video, in case he ever watches this,
mm-hmm.
And it's very minor, but I have to say the one thing about his videos that seems to not be improving, like he's improving exponentially every time he releases a new video, but the one thing that's not improving is the lighting in his videos.
That's true, like, yeah.
He does not have... he has auto white balance turned on his stop motion camera, which causes the flickering and the discoloration during the animation.
I think you're right, because like literally the only thing holding that video back was like the keying, and that's probably because of the lighting wasn't like correct.
Well,
it didn't have good lighting.
I did not know that was a thing.
It needs consistent lighting, first of all, for green screen to work. The green screen needs to be at least I think for on a Bionicle scale, I found like 2 or 3 feet away from the Bionicle is where the green screen needs to
be. Another thing, notice...
So it actually doesn't clip over him.
Yeah, another thing, you notice how he's actually has him standing on an actual piece of Lego right there at his feet? That might have been part of the problem. Instead of using one consistent background, he was like using an actual Lego piece in order to actually key the sets, which was a mistake because the lighting isn't going to be consistent that way.
And it didn't really turn out that bad with the, you can see the Lego studs on the floor. It kind of almost adds like a in focus effect to it, but that's just, you know, kind of a happy accident.
A little bit, but for the most part, it led to some keying issues, I think. Yeah, these are pretty minor complaints, though, because, like, overall, the video was just really, really good.
I really want to see him fix that white balance thing, though, because if he can do that, like, his quality will be so much nicer, and it'll be so much easier to watch his anime.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Okay.
It's simply just a camera setting he needs to turn off.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's pretty...
Or if he's using stop motion software, he needs to turn it off in the stop motion software.
Probably.
That's the only thing I saw wrong with that animation. And everything else, like, oh my god, they Creepy BioTube Stalker mentions this in some of his reviews. Making mocks look like they're breathing. That last shot with him looking up into the sky.
Oh yeah, that was a good one.
That looks so good. Like, I cannot believe how he managed to do that.
Yeah, especially how small they are. They don't really have actually a whole lot of articulation. Exactly. Except for the hands. The hands are pretty nice. But, yeah, man, this entry was so good.
Best entry by far.
Yeah. Yep, definitely best entry. Okay. That was most or all of the entries I was sent for the Bionicle Battles collaboration.
Yay!
Yay! Woo! It only took us what, like 2 hours? Almost like, let's see, we started this at like
6, so it's almost been 3 hours. Also meant no, I'm not going to Brick Fair. I don't really have the money.
I'm going to Brick Fair, Virginia.
Besides, there's MechaCon here in Florida.
I'm still debating on whether or not to go. I mean, it's so far away and there's other things I have to do. But, yeah. Okay, so I think since we've all gone through all the entries and stuff, we've given plenty of critiques or thoughts and opinions and had a good time, probably gonna end the stream so I can go rest my vocal cords and Shade can go try not to die from whatever illness he's contracted.
Yeah, I'm gonna try working on the video and also play Harvest Moon.
Oh yeah, that's a good way to handle sickness. All right, Shade2800, Wombat Combat Pictures. It was great to have you here with us.
Great to be here.
Yep, glad to have you with us.
I thoroughly enjoyed this.
Yeah, me too.
Nice actually talking to you for the very first time.
Oh yeah, this is literally the first time we have had a real-time conversation the entire time we've known each other, which has been something like 6 years. That's crazy that it took us this long to get to this point, especially because I literally talked to you more than anyone else. That was the stream.
I probably messaged you at least once a day, unless I'm really...
Ooh, that's some cool stuff. Yep. All right, see you guys later. Peace.
Bye, everyone.
See you, everyone.
Okay, bye-bye.
And stream close.
Changes are being saved. To save. You,
video is unavailable.
Yep. Oh, I thought you'd still be able to see it because you're still on the Discord server and then I shared it with you. But, all right. Whew.
That was fun.
That was quite fun. Yeah. Kind of lost some steam there at the end and everything, but we did this for like 3 hours, so that's understandable. It'd be weird if we weren't tired right now.
Yeah, I've been holding it in for like the past 40 minutes.
Oh God, yeah, jeez, like don't let me keep you here waiting. Go to the bathroom, Jesus. No, seriously, get out, get out. All right. Get out.
Nice to talk to you guys.
All right, see you later. All right, see you later, Wombat. Great to have you with us.
Yep, see you around on the interwebs.
All right.
Bye-bye. See ya.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Mm.